Well, I am here to wish you a very happy Denny Christmas. Yes, I'm here on the very, very popular Jim Norton Sam Roberts Show to wish you a holly jolly Christmas.
Yeah! Did you fuck it up?
No, I didn't.
Oh, great.
He started talking. I was potting his music up. I didn't know he was going to start talking. I was doing his music.
But his mic wasn't on at first?
No, the half a second jump. No.
Oh, no.
I normally wait until it stops and then I turn everybody's mics on.
Well, I don't think Dennis talking was part of the deal.
Yeah, I didn't know Denny was going to talk the second. I thought he was going to play for a second and then
I would have thought the same thing.
Yeah, you have to jump in.
Yeah, no, I understand. That's why. I didn't want to turn the mics on before while the intro was playing, because then if you talk, you think you're off mic.
You let the Christmas music establish a little bit.
Yeah.
And then you start talking, not like...
Yeah, then he did jump in there.
He did jump.
Jumped into the coals.
Well, welcome to the Christmas special. Holiday special.
That's true. We can't just say Christmas because we have
Yeah. Although...
The owner of the building.
We've invited Rich Voss to help us put the Christ back in Christmas.
Take the nails out of his hand.
Welcome, Rich Voss.
And we have another guest who will be here at some point.
Yes.
I'm sure.
And another guest who will be here at another point.
We have more than one?
Mark Norman just coming.
Oh, I forgot Mark's coming. Yeah, Anthony, too.
Yep, Anthony Cumia. Troy Kwan is here. The Travis dog is here.
Oof, oof, oof,
oof, oof, oof, oof, oof, oof. And of course.
Oh, Troy wasn't on.
That's all right. It's a lot of buttons today.
No.
Have you guys ever tried to get Cousin Brucey to come in here and
don't answer him? Don't answer him.
Okay, I won't acknowledge it.
Why? He's royal. I mean, don't get me wrong. Enough. I like, what's his name? But, I mean, that's royalty.
No, DJ Dennis Falcone.
I'm a big fan of
him.
Fal.
Yeah. Fal?
Yeah, I call him Fal for sure.
For phallus? What's Yeah, I got it. The gifts have already started. The gift exchange has already begun here in this very festive show.
Yes, thank you very much.
There's always one, right? There's always one staffer that gives gifts, and we're like, you don't have to give us gifts.
It's a good thing you didn't sign it.
What is it a gift card to?
I don't know. It's a little Visa card, but you don't have to give me money.
It's a bank card.
Anything you guys don't want, I'll take.
There it is. Mine wasn't actually in the...
Was it signed?
No. But the terms are here, so that's good.
That's good. The terms are important. I don't know how much it's for.
It's a Visa TD Bank gift card.
Which is very, very thoughtful.
Very thoughtful. And it's a gift for me, it says. It says for you.
Oh, yeah, for you. So I thank you.
But I don't... No, there's no...
I'm assuming they're for $500.
There's no to, from, value, or message on here.
No Merry Christmas, no...
Mm-mm. Happy Holidays.
Thanks for everything this year.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, you're just here. You just so we know whose it is. Did you get one, Troy?
Yeah.
I was in getting lottery tickets the other day, and they had.
I thought
these...
you stopped playing Lotto.
No, they weren't for me. So I they have happy holiday cards that you put the greeting
card.
I got four of them. I can give out Christmas cards, happy holidays. It doesn't say Lotto, just says happy holidays.
Oh, perfect. It's just Christmas cards.
Yes.
You should. That's a really warm feeling to get one of those. Who wouldn't want one of those on the holidays?
Sometimes I've gotten birthday cards to me and I just cross them out and put Merry.
Well, that's funny though. I mean, at least that's funny.
That's how my name would
like that. Instead of a picture of the Voss family, you get a New York State Lotto gift card.
Jersey.
I don't get a lot of Christmas cards. I get my fucking. I got my parents sent me one, and my family we do, and I get Bob sent me one. I don't get a whole lot of.
I don't. We used to.
I get. We're starting to get more and more now, but that's like I guess. As your friends start having families, they start feeling like that's something they should be doing. I don't know if we did one.
I've never sent one with my kid.
Are you doing one with your kid, with little Edgar? So you're going to be on?
I don't know. I think we took photos, but I don't know if Jess made Christmas cards or not.
Do you do
If anybody out there is family friends and did get a Christmas card from the Roberts, just know I didn't even know if we had a Christmas
card. Do you know what would be funny
itself?
Is if you did the Christmas card, you're holding him, and the card cuts off and it cuts his head so you can't see his face. You can just see just his feet.
He's a private person.
You ever do your Christmas cards with the kids on your stomach?
I've never done. I want to do them. I feel bad. Like last year, I sent one back to Bob. I didn't this year. I got it.
It'd be great if you did. If you did like a Lonely Guy Christmas cards, like you went to one of those places where families go for a Christmas photo
by myself,
and you were just there by yourself in a sweater. and just trying to look festive.
That's hilarious.
But just alone and plenty of room in the photo, right? Not cropped.
Yeah, yeah.
Not cropped clothes. Just so you knew that there was lots of room and nobody was there.
I used to get them from someone's family who's divorced now. But I have them when they were a family. So it's, you know what I
That's
mean?
That's a rare kind of, one.
It's a collector's item.
It really is.
Yeah, yeah, that is a collector's item.
Some of them are nice. The Stangles always have very funny ones.
I was about to say, I don't think I've gotten the Stangle card this year.
I haven't either. Justin and Eric, who had better not have written me off their fucking list, or I will burn your homes down.
I didn't get one, so I feel like I wouldn't be written off the list.
I don't think I would have been either.
I don't think so either.
But, so yeah, we have a couple of, I guess, little things for the... Maybe I got this. I don't know how much it's for. This is a soulless gift.
well, it's from Anthony.
From Anthony. And, but it is nice that he thought of us.
It's very nice, and I told him how much I appreciate it. But it is like it is still. There's no soul at all in it. It's emotionless. It's
me thought. And
yeah, this is a gift Paul Radley would give.
We used to give each other gifts, and then one year he goes, "Oh, I forgot yours is in my car." And he never gave it to me. I kept, and you can't say, hey.
Did I never give you that? I'm sure I had it for you.
Yeah, you did. Sorry. You did. It was in the car.
But you can't, hey, remember that gift in the car?
I'm trying to say the $700 gift.
Right.
And then I went to go take his Yeezys that he gave me to the store that, you know, buys
them. Oh, that's right. Okay, so last time Voss was here, you gave him the Yeezys because Norton had bought a whole bunch of Yeezys to wear on his special. And we had one here, right?
And so there's a place.
Hold on, and Rich, we gave it to Rich because I wasn't going to sell them.
You just don't know the culture.
Yeah, I said I don't know. You probably got like $600-$700 for them. So Rich is going to sell them, and
split the money.
Split the money
because they're like some of the. They're not new. These are one of the originals. They're probably go for like $600, $650,
maybe even more.
The second I bought them in a store.
Mm-hmm.
I took him out of the box. The guy looked at it for 1 second and went, fakes.
You gave me a pair of fake ones.
You knew they were fakes? You did.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
They're not fakes. Wait. I don't think they're fakes.
Now. Yes, because they weren't even in a real box. You should have hit me. They were fakes.
They were in a shopping
bag. They weren't even in a box. But why did you have them? Like, why did you have
fakes? I did wear them on my special. I bought a bunch of sizes. They cost me some. I mean, it was $20 a piece I paid for them.
You owe me an hour.
We gave you fake shoes. Yeah, knowing they were like really fake.
Well, because I don't know anything about those sneakers. Like if they were
but,
ones.
Oh, here they are, Rich. But there's little things you might know, like the back. The box has nothing on them.
See. I know. I was going, this is not the right box.
And there's tape on it.
It's a cardboard box.
With tape on it.
That was held together with duct tape.
No, I put the duct tape on it.
Oh, you did.
I thought maybe you bought a bunch of pairs and just threw them in a box at home.
Oh, okay.
Did it worry you at all that there was Asian writing written on the cardboard box and pen?
I didn't even see that.
This isn't even a shoebox. It's just a cardboard box.
No, I thought he just put it in the box.
Yeah, and he took them out and he said these are fake immediately.
The second I put them out, he didn't even touch them. He looked at them from me to Sam and goes, fake.
Oh, no.
And what'd you say? I go, no,
there's like 6 feet, 10 feet between us. He knew.
No, well, he could tell. And I almost said, oh, yeah, well, you're lying. He's famous. And I was going to call you to get you on the phone.
Listen.
I wish you would have.
Listen to this. You can hear it, like, clicking and stuff.
Wait, you were going to get me on the phone?
Yeah.
Oh.
I didn't.
Did you get indignant?
Kind of, I did. But I wasn't going to argue because it wasn't my. I didn't give a fuck. The only thing that bothered me was that I drove to New Brunswick. I was supposed to play golf that day.
Right.
And I blew my. You know, it wasn't too many warm days left.
No.
I still made it out to play.
Good.
At 1 o'clock instead of at 11:30.
Right.
But I had to drive to New Brunswick, which is like 25 minutes from my house.
It's an inconvenience.
Yeah, yes.
You can see the glue here, by the way, where the sole was put on.
I don't know anything about...
You can see the glue.
I didn't inspect the sneakers.
Right.
I just put
them
in.
Well, that's clear.
Yeah. Because I don't know those sneakers. I never bought a pair in my life. Yeah, he did. Well, give them.
It's not even one part. It's the entire side of the shoe. You can see the glue that connects the
sole. Is that a bad sign on a shoe?
Yeah. That's poor quality.
What size are they?
That's probably 7.
They might fit you, Denny.
You want to try them on?
Sure.
You want to rock some fucking some feezies? Yeah, some feezies.
You want these feezies?
Sure.
Oh, they'll fit him.
Thank you. He's a nice. He's a stylist.
Did you feel silly? Like, so at no point did you realize that you'd been
had? No, because I turned around and walked out quick.
You did.
with frauds in my hand.
Jim and I,
we've been giggling for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Oh, you have?
We have.
Oh my God.
You don't know, like,
we didn't say on the air, but
when we gave you the shoes that day in studio, like, both of us had to avoid eye contact with you and with each other because neither one of us could keep a straight face because we knew how fake they were.
If they were ones or 11s, I would have seen it right away.
Sure.
I've never seen a pair of those, you know.
Feezies?
Yes.
Fake Yeezys.
Try them on.
Try them on, Dennis.
Okay.
Hey, what happened? Did you turn down the tunes?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. No, no, no. I just didn't want
to
make
sure. Well, you guys really pulled one over on me, I'll tell you that.
We did.
Yes, we did.
You went 20 minutes out of your way to a fucking shoe store.
No, 25.
Yeah. And you actually went up to a shoe store and said, excuse me,
not
sir.
Not only that.
I'd like to sell these. Yeah.
After risking
they buy sneakers. Not only did I drive there.
Yeah, they don't buy fake.
They buy real sneakers.
Sneakers that Jim bought on Amazon for
$20. Not only did I drive there, I had to wait 10 minutes out front for the store to open.
Oh my God. You were there.
They
as
were
soon
running
as it
late. No, they were running late.
Of course they were.
And I'm standing out there in New Brunswick with a bunch of thugs, and I'm wearing real sneakers.
And you worried to yourself, oh man, I hope nobody robs me for these very valuable sneakers.
Well, where are Rolex?
If you had got your Rolex stolen, would that make you happy? If he had his tooth knocked out and his Rolex taken?
It's insured.
I would have been ecstatic.
You're too tight. I need
Wait, hold on,
size.
Rich. Rich, what did you say? Size? It's insured?
Yeah. Yeah, what does that mean?
You just thought it would add to the humor if you jumped in and
we're
said
making
your watch
fun of you
is insured.
You're like, but all kidding aside, I have insurance on my boo.
Let me tell you what happened the other night.
Okay.
Let me tell you how dumb and stupid my wife is.
Yes, I've known that for about 11 years.
Remember when I
did
saw
you tell her? Did you tell her the shoes were fake?
No, she goes, what are you doing? I said, I'm selling these. Me and Norton are going to split the money. And
I love that, too, that he's like willing to go to all this trouble to split the money on those sneakers, and then he still finds out they're fakes.
Do you know how hard it was?
They're Fugazis.
After the show that day, Rich comes into the office.
Oh, no.
And he doesn't have the box.
Oh, you're right.
And I said, Rich, where are your shoes? And you've never seen someone run back to the bathroom so fast.
I left them in the bathroom.
And then he comes back. He goes, I almost owe Jim hundreds of dollars if I lost shoes.
If Rich had lost the shoes and said, look, I want to pay you for them, would you have let him?
Yep.
I would have given him $200.
I would have said, look, we were going to get $600 minimum.
Right.
So I'll take $250 or $300. I would have taken $250.
Drop in the bucket.
I would have loved it if you had done that.
Me too. I left him in the bathroom.
I'm surprised nobody grabbed him. They didn't see this anonymous cardboard box with tape on it and Asian writing
on
it.
Well, I put the tape, duct tape, yes. So it didn't open.
What about this packing tape?
Yeah, the packing tape was already there. Yeah. Is the packing tape really good?
But you didn't know.
The packing tape's not that. No, the packing tape's actually, it's ripped here and it's very yellowed. There's Kanye West, known for being a high fashion sort of icon at this point, a fashionista. He would not approve this box.
No, he would not.
I just thought it was a box from home. I thought he bought like 8 pairs and 8.
So what are you going to say, Rich, about the you were going to say about the insurance? Then you went,
how dumb your wife is.
Yeah, why is she stupid? She was
saw Jim the other night. I go, we got two cushions.
By the way, you can get the shoes that Jim's shoes are modeled off of for $1,600 off GOAT. GOAT is an app, and they're going for $1,600.
Yeah.
Damn, I would have taken $6.
So she's...
So I saw Jim the other night. I go, yeah, we're going to 2 Christmas parties, one out at Governor's, and the Stan had their Christmas party. What was it? Monday night. And so I did Anthony, and then Bonnie was driving in and picked me up. So now we're driving, we're going to go to Governor's, get there at 9, from 9 to 10,
sure.
Drive back and go to the stand from like 11 to 1. So we're driving out to Long Island on the LIE, which is a fucking nightmare.
It's literally the worst road in the country.
It's probably
that or the 95 Cross Bronx, the worst road in the country.
It's fucking horrible. All of them, Belt Park, the Southern State, they're just fucking horrible.
Belt Parkway, right? Because you want to wrap one around your neck. Yeah, yeah, back to you, Rich.
What?
So,
friendly and Christmassy?
I don't think I haven't said that on stage. Anyhow.
Have you really?
Yeah, please, anybody can see that fucking horrible joke.
I've had that in my pocket since 1994.
Okay.
The Belt Parkway, there's something here.
Yes.
So we're driving out to Long Island, bumper to bumper, and now we're about 20 minutes away. I go, make sure tonight's the party. She goes to her fucking email. It's in January.
I could not be happier.
That's amazing.
I wanted to kill her. I wanted to kill her.
Did you laugh?
I was laughing because I was so mad that she's so stupid. And she's filming me telling her how stupid she is.
Why did she think it was yesterday?
Monday.
Or why did she think it was Monday?
I don't know. She just looked
what,
at it.
Actually, what would have told me that she had shitty decision making? That... There couldn't be a worse road to be on and find out you're fucking
going there for nothing.
God, I wish you would have showed up and it was just Joey Cola doing a set.
I know, just going in the parking lot. Man, we're here early. Then she bought a box, you know, for the owner because we go to pay our respect. You know,
he did say that, by the way. I almost spit on him.
Why?
He goes, you're going to go to the Christmas party. I'm like, no, I like those guys at Governors a lot, but I work, it's hard on a Monday.
It's all the way out in Long Island.
Yeah. If it was, if I was off the next day, sure. But in the verse, goes, I'm just going to pay my respect. I go, what?
Like you guys are a crime family? All you comedians are like the Sopranos?
No, so nice what, you guys, go give an you envelope? Pay your respect to them.
Pay your respect, exactly.
You know, I pay my respects. If I do the show, I try to do a good show. We chat.
Yeah. Hey, thanks. That's it.
Yeah. He is a good guy, though.
Well, I'm sure he's a good guy.
He's one of the best club owners.
But you got to pay your respects.
He reminds me of what a club owner must have been like in 1967. Yeah. Like, you know, those guys.
At
if the
Cotton
like,
Club.
Yeah, hey, how are you? For you. Like, he's one of those guys. But yeah, he treats you great.
He's what? Yeah.
Well, that's why you got to go pay your respects.
It's respect, not respects.
Oh, I mean, you sound stupid.
Sorry about that.
Yeah. Fucking idiot. Go sell some sneakers.
Oh,
that stunk.
when can we go back and just replay these things?
I have no idea.
God fucking damn this new system.
Are
they gonna fix that or they're not?
It's not a fixing issue. We're supposed to move over to a different type of system.
So we just left the system and didn't move over to the new system.
Yeah,
That's cool.
Who's going that? Because I would love to hear that.
Do away with the old one before you're ready for the new one.
Yeah,
I see.
God damn it.
Who's this card from?
I don't know. Should we get because we have Anthony Cumia coming in. Whenever Anthony arrives, he's, of course, allowed to arrive when he wants because he is not a paid employee. He's a guest.
He's a guest, yeah. He's just swinging by to the old Christmas shindig.
And now, where's Travis? Where's,
I'm right here.
Travis is there. No, he's the one. He's got the dogs and everything.
Oh, it's cool.
I'm the one in the camera.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
Where's Anthony?
He's right here. You want him?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I would like to thank him.
He's on his way in.
Those shoes don't fit you. Hi, Denny.
No, they're too small.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, wow. That. Fucking Denny's all foot.
The kid coming in there would fit him.
Probably. You were shocked when you found out these were not legitimate.
Not really.
What do you mean, not really?
Because he doesn't know sneakers. So
I thought he had been had.
I thought he got ripped off.
Now that you know that he was just, we were
giving you a hard time.
We were trying to make you look like a fool.
What size sneaker do you wear?
I'm a 9.5.
Get the other kid. What does he wear?
What's Lil Rob wear?
I have to assume a 9.
I bet Rob's an 8 or 9.
Have you checked him?
No, but...
You don't see his shoes in the morning? You don't see the size?
Well, I see his shoes. I just don't know what size he is.
Oh. Have you ever worshipped his feet?
No, surprisingly.
Thank you, Anthony. This was very thoughtful
of you. It's actually a $25 gift card.
Thank you very much. You didn't have to give us money, though.
You really didn't have to give us
anything. You don't have to give your...
It's just a little something
That's very nice.
Did you think you didn't sign it.
I know.
Are you a psychopath? You didn't just sign it.
I should have. You're right. I just wanted to...
Do that?
I completely forgot.
And mine also, I put my card back in, but my thing, it was just loose. There wasn't like...
Those things are hard to put in.
No, they're not. They're super easy. See, you just go...
See, you're struggling.
Nothing would make me happier after he gave you those. You guys fire him.
That's kind of mean.
Yeah, Jesus. Yeah, it's a mean show.
Oh, go sell some shoes.
Oh, that stunk. That was funny. Get the little kid in here.
Why?
Huh? Don't give those sneakers away.
They're not yours.
They're not yours anymore.
It was a goof.
They're half mine. One of those sneakers is mine.
You should take the left one.
You should try to sell them on eBay, like try to scam somebody and actually make some money off of them.
Ooh. Why don't I start a criminal business?
You've been doing that for 30 years.
What size sneaker do you wear?
8. It's close.
Well, one size off. Yeah. Close enough.
I bet they'll fit him.
You want to put them on? Put on the feezies?
They don't fit me. They're tight and the on the feezies. 7. They're like 7.
They're shit.
They're smaller than 7.
I hate to throw the card out, though.
No, you can.
Yeah, I don't want to either. I almost don't want to spend the $25 gift card because I don't want to take it out of the sentimental
card.
I'll take it.
Thanks, Dennis.
I'm gonna mount this
Yeah.
In my home, I only have one Christmas card mounted.
Just to remind me of like the impact that I made on my staff this year.
Yeah. I didn't even get my parents one yet. It'll probably come soon.
I didn't get my mother anything.
No, they didn't send it. I never get Christmas cards.
Well, she's died Bob's 2 years display, ago. But
that's probably why. Appreciate that very much, Anthony.
Thank you very much.
How come you didn't write on them?
I thought the guy was going to write like $25 and everything, and then I was going to sign it, but he didn't write anything, and I just completely forgot.
Okay.
Just going to hand them to everyone.
Well, look, I'm not one to look a gift horse in the mouth, you know?
That's true. Thank you very much.
Did you get Don Wicklin anything?
What happened?
You get Don Wicklin anything?
He told me not to get him anything. He like was adamant.
What's he going
to
say?
Yeah, well, true.
He's the boss. He has to say that.
He told you that in advance?
Yeah. Well, because I was like, what, you know?
The only time anybody ever says in advance, hey, don't you get me anything.
Is when they want you to forget him.
You know, got him at least a little something.
Well, a little something.
Yeah, I was going to get him the same thing, but he was like, if you get me anything, you know, please don't get me anything.
Did you get Ope anything?
Who? Now that we've gotten our gift from Anthony, I guess we can bring Rob back in so that he can give us his gift, right?
Does he? Oh yes, that'd be nice. Bring him in.
Bring Rob in to give us
awesome
to give us the gift card from him.
Thank you, Rob.
Right, right.
I mean,
that's the appropriate thing to do,
isn't
it?
You know, I thought we were all giving gifts.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Right.
Are you taking the staff out? Like you and Jim taking the staff out?
We can't today. Hold on. We no. The answer.
In a word.
No, we're going to do something in the new year. Definitely.
Yeah. Jan party. Mm-hmm.
So do you have a couple of gift cards for the boys?
No, I didn't bring anything.
What?
I didn't. No, I'm sorry, guys.
But we're like...
I know.
We're your superiors. You're supposed to shower us with gifts.
You're right. I know. I didn't want to feel pressured. I didn't know what to get. I didn't want to get just gift cards.
But you look like
that's a shot at you.
Yeah, like what?
But you look like you come from such a better family than him.
Yeah.
That you would know to do that.
Yeah, one is a well schooled boy, one is rough and tumble.
Right. Collared shirt under the hoodie.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. 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 Presentable for work.
Not so much.
No, not at all.
No.
But who brings in the gift card?
Who brings in? Right.
It's the boy who went to the School of Hard Knocks.
That's right.
Should we present our gifts to the boys?
We should, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Everybody? All right, I'll go first. Everybody shut your eyes.
Nope. But wait, now, do these come with them, or do these come separately?
Well,
Rob's eyes are open. Shut your eyes.
I'm just going to give them their gifts.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. So, I know you guys have worked really hard.
Yes, you have.
And, you know, Sirius doesn't always pay.
They don't always help out at the end.
So this should help you guys. Here you go. And Anthony,
wait, your eyes have to remain closed.
There you go.
And we have to. I have
and
one of each.
You have something for them, too?
I do, but I'll hand it to Sam to hand to you.
Okay. All right. And by the way, Troy and Travis, just so you guys know, a little something
eyes
for you
closed,
guys.
Boys.
You shouldn't have done that.
Eyes
you guys
closed.
Really didn't have to.
Look at that.
Oh, so wonderful.
And
wow.
And one,
is that great?
And one, hold on.
Okay, man. Keep your eyes shut. Don't say anything about, don't get too excited, Troy. Don't spoil it for the boys.
One for these, and I got Travis's here.
Okay.
Eyes closed, boys.
Eyes closed.
They're afraid we're going to do
something. A little something for you.
Can I open my eyes?
No.
That's right. You cannot.
That's, here you go, in that hand, that's...
Very, very nice.
And...
Ooh!
There you go, ooh! All right, everybody open your eyes!
Happy holidays!
Merry Christmas!
Oh, wow!
Santa
Happy
Claus
holidays!
Came.
Yay!
Santa Claus came!
You guys really didn't have to.
What'd you guys get?
I am...
Wait, hold on, don't say, because Travis didn't get his!
Oh, right. Oh, okay. Yeah, should I bring his in
yeah,
there?
Yeah, bring in the Travis, okay. Hold on, I got this one for the Travis dog.
Okay, all right.
Okay.
Okay. No peeking, Travis.
Come on,
Jim,
Travis.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
Oh,
I really
you're welcome.
Too.
Sorry,
this is amazing.
You're good boys.
Yeah.
Well, here comes Sam.
Possibly the best Christmas ever.
All right, I'm going to close my eyes.
Okay, no peekies.
No peekies.
No peekies.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, I got my presents.
Happy Christmas!
Can I open my eyes?
No.
Why?
No peekies, Travis.
No peekies.
No peekies. That's what she said as she got into the car.
Okay.
tied down the hatch.
All right.
Open them. Yay!
Ooh!
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Tell the listeners.
Sorry, the papers are taped together.
What'd you guys get?
A Not Sam pin and to my number one fans, Chippa. Signed autograph.
Wow.
A black and white printed.
right from a white.
You got my the number one fan one?
I got my Chippa autograph says one. To my fan number one. You know, this is great because I didn't have either of these things.
Wait a minute. Rob, can I see this for a second? This one, it looks like Chip might have used some scrap paper because there are websites on the top and like a link on the bottom.
I like how it's folded.
Yes, it was folded. And Anthony, yours was folded, but it's also
scrap paper's from August.
It's off center.
Oh yeah, no!
Unfortunately, there's a large.
And he signed with black on black writing.
Yeah, black on a black and white.
And my fan Chip.
Like crime.
Chip, I mean, Troy, do you like the gifts?
Yeah.
He's speechless.
Well, yeah, congrats, everybody. I didn't realize.
Right.
Yeah, that's. I feel silly, but
I gotta go out and buy a frame now.
Yeah.
So Travis, you have to buy a weird size frame.
Yeah, that's fine. Or, you know, I could just cut it to size.
Oh, you could do that.
But that might
then it'll lose its value, though.
Yeah. Travis's photo is printed across two sheets of paper.
Yeah, and taped together. Because there was a mistake.
I can tell what website he was on.
Yeah, because Jim's printer. No, that was from Jim's Good Boy computer.
Yes, no, I know.
Tweeted a picture.
Well.
Wow. Yuck.
One Anthony must move.
Yeah, let's switch out the
so the other one may...
Well, look what your saloon blew in.
Hello.
You missed the presentation of gifts.
You missed the gift giving.
Already?
Yeah.
He's not too late for the eats.
Look what look what the staff got.
Yeah. Oh
my goodness. A signed
Chip Chipperson.
Picture of Chip Chipperson.
And and a Not Sam pin.
Oh, wow. I don't know which one is better.
Yeah.
Well, look.
This is a really special day.
Look, for Anthony.
No!
Oh, wow.
So look at that.
Anthony, I'm fresh out of pins. I'm sorry.
Oh, it's
Why
nice.
Did I actually think from that picture that it was like a 8x10 glossy or something? It's literally printed out.
It's scrap paper.
Scrap paper. It's been used for something else.
Anthony, is yours on one or two pieces of paper?
Hey, this is on an Anthony's been fired memo. wait a minute.
From where?
Hi, Rich.
This is really a wacky radio, man.
It's crazy.
Yeah, well, we have to give
staff some gifts.
I like
it.
It's nice.
Thank you.
Chip looks cool in this picture.
Yeah, it's a good shot.
A Siggy in his mouth?
Yeah.
It's a hot picture.
It's nice. Good. Chip didn't have a color printer, huh? Just black and white.
Well, he did. But, you know, black and white.
A little more economical.
Yeah. Went through a lot of black ink on this one.
Yeah. That is true.
Kind of wasteful.
That was wasteful.
Yeah.
But the same thing would have happened if it was in color. The black would have been on the bathroom.
Well, of course.
Yeah, sure.
So how you doing, man?
Good. Good.
Is it hard getting up twice in the same week early?
No. No. Yeah, it is. It's terrible.
It is, right?
No. I take my naps. Is what I do. From doing morning radio here for so long, over the course of the years, I was able to just, you know, crap on any time I want.
You want your seat back?
No, I'm good.
Did you go home or did you stay in the city?
Stay in the city. Stayed at the apartment. The other night, I was at the Friars Club.
Ooh!
And hanging out. Yes.
Whoa!
I
took you there?
What was it, a roast?
Trying to find targets?
Yeah. I was over there having a little meeting about Compound Media, of course. And I go back to my apartment. It was probably somewhere around 2A. And then at 4 a.m., where I usually would have gone to the karaoke bar, some guy shot and killed right outside the karaoke bar that I go to, Tonic.
Yeah,
wow.
The street actually yesterday morning was closed.
Yeah.
Even when we came to work.
What's this, like 50th Street or something in that area?
Yeah, it's like 49th, 48th, and 7th.
Right next to the
7th.
Strip joint.
Yeah, right next to the strip joint. Right.
Yeah, I think they got
very
shot.
Very good. Of course. He knows.
Yeah, Denny, of course, Denny knows.
Of course,
yeah.
Denny knows. It's next to the strip joint.
Yeah,
next to the gay club?
No.
Okay, so they got shot and killed right outside.
Somebody got shot in the head. Yeah.
Right in the head.
Wow. That's a good thing. Who doesn't want to do that at a karaoke bar?
It was, I guess, some argument between two gentlemen outside on the sidewalk resulted in somebody getting their head
ventilated. You know, isn't that funny that you never know who you're fucking arguing with? Like, you never know. You got to sense to just walk away sometimes.
Yeah, that
especially
really
road
is.
Rage.
Road rage.
Yeah, yeah.
Did they find out who did it?
No, but please.
What do you mean? What do you mean?
You know.
Do you think they'll find out who did it?
Probably.
Yeah, it's usually guys that knew each other.
That's good. Yeah, yeah.
They start yapping. That. Yeah.
NYPD is pretty on top of
it. But it wasn't the karaoke bar that's...
No, but it was right in front of it. Yeah.
How far is that from your place? Not far.
Couple of blocks, okay. Yeah.
Near the strip joint.
I'm right
Stop
by the
that,
Rupert yeah. Pupkin, the Jerry Langford building over there.
Oh, yeah. Same apartment, right?
Yeah, yeah.
How long have you had that place?
Probably 6 years now. Yeah.
It helps?
Yeah, it's so much better than...
the commute, right?
Humping out to Long Island
so,
and
you
shit.
You don't stay there a lot. I mean, do you...
No, sometimes I'll be there. Like, I've been there the entire week. I haven't, you know...
Oh, wow.
Been,
I heard you Airbnb it when you're not there.
That's what I do, yeah. Airbnb
Could you ever Airbnb your place?
Never!
I couldn't either.
And then in good conscience go and sleep in the bed and... God knows what those slobs are doing in there.
Never. Oh, yeah. Father of three shot to death outside.
Father of three?
That's right.
After holiday party? What the... Oh, they were at Tonic.
Well, it was 4 a.m., hanging out with colleagues from a Harlem Buffalo Wild Wings restaurant. They were investigating. They said it was arguing with a woman who was outside the bar with two men. One of the men pushed him, and the other one shot. So he's arguing with this woman.
Oh, my
She's with two
God.
Guys. One pushes him, one shoots him. I mean, what the fuck is
Dude,
wrong with people?
That, one of the two men were wearing a black skull cap and black jacket.
Hmm.
He was still being sought late Tuesday. Mm.
But I mean, like, just literally, you're out there at 4 a.m., you're having a dumb argument with some lady, and one guy, now you get shot in the
Wait,
head.
Wait, no, so one of the guys was with the lady as a spouse, and the other guy...
I don't know what their relationship was.
Yeah, the
I
victim.
Thought maybe you knew. You're invested.
But by the way, as we're saying this...
You have three kids.
My Siri just turned on and was, like, just quoting everything I just said. How many people have gotten fucked? And I've talked about this before.
Yeah.
When you're in a text message with your wife or your girlfriend and you don't send and not realizing it and just keep talking. Like, you ever been in a cab and you're like, okay, listen, I'm going to come back. Oh, make a left here, please. And then it shows up.
Oh,
how
boy.
Many people have fucked up like that? And
Siri
ruined...
says, you're always talking?
Yeah. You know, it's better when you say it in computer language. The Camparis.
What's the matter?
Yeah, that's frightening, you know.
Just an argument, all of a sudden you're
that's
dead.
That's why I fucking steer clear of any arguments in Times Square. I would never...
Yeah, because it could
right.
come back to haunt you.
You never know. Yeah. You never know, do you?
Whoopsie.
Then again, you don't know what this guy was, you whose fault it was.
I would say whoever, no one deserves to get their head fucking split open
by a bullet.
As you're, as you're just leaving a bar. Yeah, maybe a little drunk, some fucking...
They thought they had the
Some
life,
woman
though.
Out there on the sidewalks getting a little lippy.
Sure.
But they work at Buffalo Wild Wings. They're having their big party.
Fun.
Like, everything is going right.
Really, I guarantee
you think they ruined the party?
They were singing some karaoke, probably.
Well, the girl was probably with a dude. Got lippy with another dude, and the dude shot the other dude.
Stop saying dude.
Guy.
Dude. Bro.
Imagine he was up there right before he left doing karaoke, just going, hit me with your best shot. Yeah. And then ironically enough.
Somebody decided
Someone
to.
Did.
Fuck that guy.
Shot through the heart in your tube. You know, and then bam.
You're shot
the bitter, bitter irony, Sam.
It's true. Mm. Except you were shot in the head. Not in the heart.
It would be a little more ironic if it was in the head, but still some irony.
Shot right through the temple, but you're to blame.
Yeah.
What if his nickname was Sheriff?
I shot the sheriff, probably. Right. Or, yeah.
Sure.
Wait, like his own... Jimmy, is just as bad as his stuff.
What if his nickname was Sheriff?
And the other guy's singing. And the other guy's singing.
What are the chances of that, Jim?
Zero. Zero. Even if his real name is Buford T. Justice.
A little bit of a stretch.
Shit.
A little bit. That's okay.
Yeah, we all...
Throw him out there.
Does this make sense? When you're going
if it's
to
coming
a party,
out of your mouth, no.
No, probably not.
When you're going to a party.
No, it probably
you're
makes.
The club and you go, yeah, I'm going out to pay my respect. Don't, respect.
Respect.
Respect?
Right, respect.
Like
respect. He was going out respect. To a club
pay
owner's
my,
party.
Do you ever say, I'm no. going to pay my respect
no.
to somebody?
I don't think I ever say that.
No one's ever said
unless
that.
Unless it's like a wake.
Unless it's a dumbbell watching a bad mob movie and trying to sound like he's in the know. No, no one says that in our business.
Pay my respect.
Gonna go pay my respect.
And it's respect.
My respect.
That's what I said.
No, you said respect, well, and you corrected me when I said
respect. It doesn't matter.
Respect.
He doesn't have a call. You don't have a thing. You can't prove it.
It's broken.
You follow that one, Troy?
No. The playback is broken.
Right. No, you're right. You're right.
I wish it wasn't.
Because Voss has already made a few blunders this morning.
That one blunder.
And a horrible bomb, too.
Really?
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, my God.
Worse than that sheriff one?
No. That was the follow-up. That was the staying alive of Voss bombs. The Saturday Night Fever you missed. The other one was really bad. Yeah, and we had Voss.
Did you hear about the shoes?
No.
We gave,
you guys pack a lot into the first half hour.
We certainly did. It was fun-filled, some
I bet.
We gave Voss, knowingly, we gave him a pair of bootleg Yeezys that were really, really fake.
No. $20 I paid for.
Really fake.
Really fake.
Did you buy more than one pair of the fake ones? Yes, I bought like four pairs. I wore fake Yeezys on my last special, so I didn't know what size would fit, so I bought like six of them from this website.
This is the Yeezy box.
Look at this thing.
You know what size fits in your ass.
Look at the they usually Asian come, writing.
It's Chinese writing on here.
So Voss actually took them home and brought them to a sneaker store in New Brunswick.
I told him we'd get like 600, we'd split it.
He said God. And what did the guy say?
The second I took them out of the box, he went, fake.
Get out of here.
That's what they do. They buy and sell sneakers.
But Voss argued a little bit. Like, no, I don't think so.
I did.
No.
I said, you're wrong. He's a celebrity.
But do the real ones have labels on it that say the brand of the sneaker? And in real size, there's nothing in this.
I just didn't pay attention. It was big deal. You know, you live and learn.
That's true.
You do. You've done one, not the other. I wish you weren't doing one.
I left my phone at home today.
Oh no!
Whoa.
And it's been. I'm enjoying it right now.
No, you're not.
No one. I feel out of sorts.
Isn't that bullshit?
It's not bullshit.
When people go, I left my phone at home. I couldn't be happier.
Well, I wouldn't go that far, but
I would panic.
I realized like 5 minutes after I left the house that I didn't take the phone out of the charger, and I went, you know what? Fuck it.
Yeah.
And I drove in. I turned on the traffic report on the radio. Whoa. And then I changed my route based on what they were reporting. It was no GPS, no nothing.
Do you know what
crazy.
I felt like a man. For the first time.
Slow down.
Yeah. When I was going to Australia, I said I flew Qantas, which was just fucking the worst. And they have no fucking Wi-Fi in this shit airline. And I'm in the middle, I'm like, where's the Wi-Fi? They're like, we don't have it yet. Maybe next year. I'm like, what do you mean you don't have it?
Yet.
And the guy said, and the guy goes, well, you know, if you're the businessman and you want to get away from the email. I'm like, is that how they tell you to spin this? I literally almost fucking had an air rage incident.
That's all nasty.
You really think that's how you, you're right. No businessman emails. Shut up.
Yeah, I might not want to get things done while I'm traveling halfway around the world.
Yeah, that's the worst. We get it next year. Oh, thanks. That helps me now.
Perfect.
Yeah, I know.
Perfect.
Qantas was the worst.
Was it? That's surprising. Worst. I always thought it was a good airline.
They were awful.
You don't enjoy a little bit like not having Wi-Fi on a plane?
No, because I don't have to buy it if I don't want it. If I don't want it, I don't get it.
Right.
Yeah. What are you, Grizzly Adams now, trying to fucking just get away from it all?
What was the Bears name?
The Revenant.
Was it Ben?
Yeah. I don't know. Grizzly Adams Bear. I don't know. No, I don't think it was Ben. Gentle Ben.
I'm thinking. I used to cry. They said when Gentle Ben Gentle ended. Ben. My mother said that whenever Gentle Ben, whenever Gentle Ben was over, I would cry.
Oh, I bet. He wasn't very gentle. That's Gentle Ben.
I always cry because I love Gentle Ben. Gentle Ben.
I never saw the program. I thought you were referring to Big Ben.
He was better than when Rough Bob came over.
What's the music for Gentle Ben, the bear show? I don't remember what it was, but I remember it was about a bear.
That was Clint Howard.
Kid. I remember the little kid.
Clint Howard. It was Ron Howard's brother.
Oh, was that him?
Yeah, his little brother was on there.
Gentle Ben theme.
Never took off like Andy Griffith.
No, it didn't.
Wait, was there a...
You know why you'd cry when this was over? This is old
music.
Yeah.
Do they show the opening at all or no? I want to see the opening, what Gentle Ben was to the boy. But the best part is the boy leaning against the bear, and that bear in that picture has a fucking chain around its neck. Oh, here it is. Yeah,
of course you're going to cry when this is over.
Oh, Dennis Weaver was the father.
It's swimming time after this. It's time to go to the pool. And
Dennis Weaver.
Oh, my God. How fucking old school is this? Oh, look at the boy.
Clint Howard
playing with cubs.
Playing with the little bear cubs.
Beth Brickle is there.
Beth Brickle.
Watching.
She was great.
And those look like the huts that changed.
And Gentle Ben.
Gentle Ben. Oh.
I used to love Gentle Ben. Don't worry, mauled Clint Howard's genitals.
I missed that episode.
Yeah, with his claws, because Clint Howard spilled some honey on his crutch. And Gentle Ben mauled his genitals with his teeth and claws.
Thought his little bag was a wasp's nest. Licking the honey up. that's a hell of a show. That's when America was great.
Yeah,
I think. You know, make America great again. Right back to that time. My neighborhood is nice.
Oh, I see.
1967.
Yeah, that's true.
Did you like Flipper?
You know, I'm sure I did, and of course Lassie. But Gentle Ben was my guy.
Flipper. Yeah, that was going.
I do remember BJ the BJ and the Bear.
You remember BJ, all right? Why does it always go
back? BJ
because
McKay.
He did so. He
that was
more dicks than he watched episodes of this show when he was growing up.
Yeah, and it was in syndication. did you watch BJ McKay and this is? Do you remember the song BJ and the Bear?
No, I didn't watch that. I wasn't born in the 60s.
It was Greg a Evigan. Chimp.
How many
it
bears?
It was Greg Evigan and a chimp. He was a truck driver.
That's right.
And his buddy was a little chimp, and it would drive around. He would drive around.
Yeah, BJ
get
McKay.
Into adventures.
Was it 80s? Was this 80s?
Here it is. No, it's not 80s.
It was
like 70s,
maybe.
Oh, jeez.
The chimp's driving the truck?
The chimp is driving the truck?
I think he might be using
just
camera.
Oh, he's just pulling the horn.
That doesn't seem right.
Right. I love this show, too. I liked it. It's 80s.
So when you grow up,
I did not think this
bears.
Was 80s. That deserved a little bit. Rich.
What did you say? I didn't hear him.
That doesn't matter.
At this point,
threw it out.
It wasn't lost on me. I liked it.
Yeah.
They needed words to the songs in the 80s.
Yeah.
In the 60s, like that with the Gentle Ben and stuff, music was fine enough.
By the way, can you go back a little bit?
And
what's happening right here? No, just so watch. Greg Evigan's driving. Look, he's looking out the window having a conversation. Who's he talking to right here? Watch.
Maybe BJ.
Yeah, he's driving. Wait.
He's driving around
maybe he's on his
corner.
No, you'll see. He's driving.
Oh.
He's leaning out the window, talking out the window to
like
who?
A truck driver would talk to maybe a pretty seat cover out there.
Yeah, hot chick.
A beaver. Maybe he's on a beaver hunt out there. Telling someone about the Smokies
hunt.
Up there. And he's got a chimp. What?
Oh, the cutest little guy.
What a horrible life for the monkey being taken on the fucking road in a truck. With a hat and his little coveralls.
What a horrible fucking thing for the trucker. You got nothing with those two little fans and you got this fucking primate shitting in your fucking driver's seat.
Yeah, that just doesn't seem like it would. He's wearing Rich Voss's hat.
Yeah, exactly. But there's more going on underneath it.
Whoa.
Did you ever want a pet monkey?
Everyone wanted a pet monkey.
A pet monkey?
Yes.
Oh, you watch The Little Spider Rascals. Monkey. Claude Akins.
Yeah.
You'd watch The Little Rascals and stuff, and Spanky would have the monkey, and it would just look like a fun thing to have if you were a kid. A little monkey.
Yeah.
What about Flipper?
Dress him up.
I like Flipper.
Flipper was stupid because you had to be in the fucking water.
Yeah, that's great.
Like, Gentle Ben could come into the house.
Yeah.
You know, the Greg Evigan's monkey could leave the truck and do that. It's like, oh, let's play with Flipper. Yeah, I don't feel like getting wet today.
Yeah,
I'm cold.
Or put a hook in Flipper's mouth and bring him in the living room and watch him suffocate. Throw the little cunt in a tub.
How about My Mother in a Car?
That's an old one.
Jerry Van Dyke,
My Mother the Car. Oh, this was Flipper?
If your mother was a car, she should have had her garage aborted. They should have put a hanger in her garage. Pulled out that Ed's.
Keep it going.
This isn't the theme,
no,
though.
No, this is not the theme.
Just like fucking, just like game porn.
Was very whimsical to a Flipper. Very whimsical.
Flipper. You know it was in the Flipper movie.
Who?
Michael Madsen, right?
Oh. That's oh, yeah, when he
Michael
goes,
Madsen,
yeah.
That was
like,
when he was
like, yay, Flipper.
Oh, he's trying to be good natured and
trying to be
just
friendly,
doesn't work.
Yeah, he's trying to be dad.
Michael Madsen. Doesn't he go in and he fucking cuts Flipper's fin off?
That's right.
And he sings into it.
He dances around.
He didn't know who Chip was.
Dances around.
He did not know who Chip was.
What's that? From My Three Sons? No, not that Chip.
No, he's, yeah. Is this the song?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is terrible.
Yeah.
The show sucked.
What a dud. Flipper was a dud,
it was
Denny.
For dorks.
Yeah. Exactly. People,
it was all like these kids befriending animal shows were like a big thing back then.
This was bunk.
They had one in Australia called Skippy. Skippy the Bush Kangaroo.
What?
And that was a show also where the kids would be playing with that? Skippy a kangaroo. I don't know. It was on TV here back in...
Oh, let me hear the theme for
19,
this.
1960.
Yeah. Don't date yourself.
None of your beeswax. There it is.
Oh, this is great. Is this where the kid goes to pet it and the kangaroo jumps up and puts his claws in the kid's fat stomach?
Disembowels him.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, Skippy.
Here's the episode where Jimmy complains about Qantas.
Exactly. I'm complaining they don't have any Wi-Fi. And Ed Devereaux says, what is that? And Tony Bonner.
Tony Bonner.
Holy shit. Ken James has a good head of hair. He's an Australian boy. Gary Prankhurst. Always Prankhurst. I did one called Prankhurst where they told me there was things hidden in my hiney on April Fool's. I said Prankhurst. Oh, look at the boy's shirt.
Yeah, he's...
Look at the kangaroo looking off at his fucking trainer.
At his trainer, yeah.
Who's holding up a whip or a club.
A cattle prod.
I'm sure back then, those animals were told what to do with a cattle prod whip.
Just,
and
it's just zapping the whole time.
If you claw this boy's stomach, I'm going to put this on your genitals again. And the kangaroo knows that his little wet lipstick is going to get fucking zapped if he claws the fat boy's stomach.
Because it's just a mass grave of kangaroos during the season.
Yeah.
They just...
Bring in a new one.
Bring in another Skippy.
Yeah,
all dead via severe electrocution to the genitals.
Is that possible?
I don't know.
I don't know.
Skippy was a bit of a douche.
Yeah, Skippy.
But you like Flipper, huh, Dennis?
I like Flipper.
Flipper sucked.
Oh, another episode where Flipper jumps out of the water and does that swim backwards thing.
And he gives them like some of the news that something's happening.
Yeah. You got to help him. Oh, we'll follow you in the boat.
Can't wear a hat.
Yeah, please.
Did you ever go on vacation and swim with the dolphins? Did you ever do that?
I did that at Atlantis in the Bahamas. Yes.
I never did.
They're probably really happy, those dolphins.
Good. I think Travis did that too.
Yeah, it's great.
He adopted the dolphin too. It was apparently left in a car. It was very hot.
Well, the dolphins actually thought they were signed up for Swim with the Orphan.
I want to know if Anthony remembers me and the chimp. Remember we were talking about that a couple weeks ago?
Yeah, Travis.
Why would you...
What are you doing?
Why would you lob these at me?
Yeah, wait. What's it called?
Oh, no.
Chimp. It's called Me and the Chimp.
Yeah. Me and a monkey were running around.
Nope. Chimp Chimperson.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Me.
Was it that woman that has no face that started Me and the Chimp?
Oh, my God. Her name... Don't tell me her name was... Connecticut. I forget. Charlotte Nash.
Charla Nash. Yeah. Me and the Chimp, and the chimp tear off my face and all my extremities.
That?
Yeah.
Oh, God. That looked like Artie's nose.
Poor Artie. That's terrible.
That's the real life Me and the Chimp.
That's what happens. Greg Evigan's fucking chimp right there.
She's better now, though.
Oh, wouldn't that be great if the chimp jumped up, just started eating Greg Evigan's balls and clawing his face, and the truck careens into a family of five?
Took her hat off. How do you enter?
You know, she's blind.
Yeah, she's blind. It ripped her eyes out.
She's got no eyeballs.
Oprah's got to sit there and interview.
It attacked her for 12 minutes. It bit her fingers off.
Maybe you don't want a monkey as a pet.
And they couldn't fix any of it? They did. That was swollen. She's fixed now.
Which I wouldn't say fixed, but...
How does she look now?
Better.
Put a London broil in the chair and just fucking interview that.
After it gets flung at Tony Soprano's neck?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Wow, that's brutal. That's disgusting.
Now look at Charlotte Nash 2014. She looked better. She's probably better now.
Oh.
He walks in and Uncle
Junior's
like,
that's her after the face transplant.
It's actually a lot better.
It's a lot better, but I wouldn't go so far as to say fixed.
Holy shit.
Besides my parents, there were five siblings.
She's the poor lady because she has to breathe.
Daughter, her name is Adriana.
Through her neck, I think.
Oh, how is that working out?
Through her mouth.
The good news is she doesn't have to blink anymore.
Dude, she could go out. She could literally travel and nobody would stare at her. Like, that's amazing.
Yeah. Oh, better than that. Better than it was because, yeah, that was a...
Poor lady can't breathe.
Not much emotion going on in that face, though.
No, not at all.
Otto should be working her. Her dumb face. Look at her dumb face. She's still blind, though. Those are fake eyes. You know, they can't do that.
What's that?
Ripped out her eyes.
Ripped out. That's what chimps
do. Yeah. Eyeballs.
When they fight, they try to immobilize their opponent or whatever. So or their rival. So they'll bite the balls off so you can't reproduce. They bite your fingers off and they rip your eyes out. Chimps are very, very nasty.
Yeah.
And that's just for starters.
I'd be so upset. A chimp started attacking me because you just know
it's over, Johnny.
My balls, eyes, and fingers are all gone.
They fuck it. What do you protect, right?
Yeah.
I would
probably.
Oh, you
got to
protect your ball. Your wallet.
Fucking karate chop them.
You got to protect your balls, but then they're gouging your face out.
I feel like I go for the eyes first and then accidentally lose my balls.
Oh, and you're just going to sit there not looking while he rips your balls off?
And then he just bite your fingers off so your eyes wouldn't have any protection.
Right. Yeah, I'd be so fucked.
Really, the fucking chimps are like cartels.
They really. I got to get organized.
Yeah.
Taking his bananas and piling them on the desk. I got to get organized.
That's the best organization. He hangs up the phone.
Hangs up the phone and like moves a speaker around.
Yeah,
and then he's set. He's ready to go to war with Sosa.
Boy, did Sosa wipe him off the map.
Oh, didn't take long, did it? Told him not to fuck with you little monkey. See, it all ties back together.
That's right.
Wow, that Shorla Nash.
What's Neil deGrasse Tyson saying about, he's on CNN, what's he saying about UFOs?
He's basically saying, look, if there's so many UFOs,
bring them into the town square.
Bring one of the bodies into the town square.
The town square.
Yeah, just bring it into the town square.
Where is he?
Which one is that? What number is that?
We don't have it because we had to sacrifice it for Denny's Christmas music. But if you want to hear some Christmas music, you could turn up Denny.
I would like to know what the hell is happening with these UFOs. A lot of people comment saying there's a lot going on.
And someone saying it was fake, but that looked pretty real.
That pilot, I guess, was part of a documentary about aircraft carriers. And he's legit. And then he said it was when I saw it, it was otherworldly.
It was other how come we can't worldly. See the color world, the color version? It records. We're seeing the infrared version.
I think it was pitch black out. It was nighttime.
Nighttime in the
sky.
Oh,
it was. They said it was white. Okay, I don't know.
And they were tracking it. They got it on infrared. They locked it on. You could see that. He should have just. You know what? Fuck it. Launch 2.
No.
Come on, Fox 1. Whoosh. And just launch that motherfucker, shoot it down, and then, you know, you're the guy that started an interstellar war.
Yeah, how do you know that it doesn't have some kind of fucking, you know...
A shield or something? If it had a shield...
Huh?
Yeah, I really wanted to see how long it was going to take him to get to force field.
I'm not a Star Trek guy. No, so I don't know that stuff.
I was a Lost in Space guy.
It's anything. Oh, I'm sure.
That was a good TV show.
Oh, dear. Yes.
Oh, God. I love it.
I love little Jimmy Robinson.
Oh.
Bill Mummy.
Will.
What's that?
Billy Mummy.
Billy Mummy and Will
and
Robinson.
Billy Daddy.
Angela Cartwright.
Oh, no. Dennis Penny. Falcone. Going to be some competition for the young boy. Oh, dear.
You think he liked young Will?
Spare me the poisonous barbs and play some ABBA. Yeah.
And Danny.
Oh, jeez.
That is great.
Both do impressions.
We should, right? Yeah.
That wouldn't work.
Nope. Yep.
Troy, do you feel vindicated with all this UFO talk, especially since you kind of put, you attempted anyway, to put Neil deGrasse in his place a couple times?
Who's Neil deGrasse?
Neil deGrasse.
Sometimes, you know, we millennials like to shorten things.
That is true.
You know what I mean? Just, we like to throw
hopefully
on
it's your lifespan.
Maybe when he comes in, you could pay your respect.
You mean he's your life, fun of not you. Your lifespan.
Wow.
He's making fun of you.
Denny.
Respects.
Coming in hard.
Pay your respects.
With a T at the end.
I think you do that
with an S at the end. Why would you put a T at the end of respects?
You only pay one respect.
I was taking a shit.
You're talking into your coffee cup. At the 30th of stand-up.
Dan Aykroyd is a big believer in all this.
He did it on purpose.
That's cool, because Dan Aykroyd really is the guy I go to.
Yeah.
He is the go-to UFO expert.
Absolutely. What
just
is
like
Chevy
a Blink-182 guy.
Yeah, Blink-182, yeah. Ghostbusters.
Blink-182 guy. I could see some fucking idiot like that guy from Blink-182 making a lot of money with the band, and then he goes online one night, fucked up, stoned, whatever it is,
zooted.
And sees some UFO. You zooted. Thank you, Chip.
Right.
And sees something on UFOs, and then it's like, yeah, I'm going to dedicate my life to that now.
And then he leaves Blink.
I know. Yeah,
he's
yeah.
not in Blink 182 anymore.
People are hoping that I fucking find something that I become passionate about.
Oh, they,
yeah, me.
Or you stop blinking.
So, Troy, do you feel vindicated? You had Neil deGrasse Tyson in here.
Where is Bond?
You were trying to explain to him that there's all this evidence. He kept talking about the goddamn town square.
Hell yeah.
He's still going to be an asshole.
Wow.
He is, because you don't like Neil deGrasse. I love him.
I, you know, I really don't.
I think he's kind of a tool, to be honest with you.
Wow, geez.
And he just puts up that stupid bullshit about, like, bring the body. Where's the body?
Where did he want you to bring
it? But Troy, he is a scientist, and those guys have a weird level of proof.
He's playing stupid is what he's doing.
Where does he want you to bring the body?
He wants to bring it out so everybody sees it.
To where,
though, there's so much information, and finally this stuff comes out.
Where does he want the body to be brought? What part of the town?
Town square?
That's right.
The town square.
I don't think he's in the know, though.
No, of course he is.
No, I'll tell you why I don't think so.
Michio Kaku, he knows. Have you ever seen interviews with him? He knows what's going on.
Michio Kaku knows about UFOs?
Yes. Fucking Bin Laden's body?
What's that?
Was he yelling, bring out Bin Laden's body?
In town square?
Here's why I don't think so.
There's evidence that Bin Laden existed.
Because those guys are...
There's no evidence he was really killed.
There's no those guys are never they don't scientists can't go out on the limb on that stuff because they don't even investigate it sometimes. They'll be laughed out of the bit. They'll be like the laughing stock. So a lot of times those guys don't even pursue it in their business because they'll be mocked.
Is that true or is that the story that
that's
we're
the
told?
Story they want you to hear,
right?
No, I believe it.
I'm sure there's scientists that'll be like, hey, listen, wink wink, nudge nudge, this is what's really going on.
Because Neil deGrasse Tyson would be what a hero he'd be if he talked about it.
Yeah, but he'd also, those people that come out and say stuff like that are threatening their lives.
But Tom DeLonge is not being threatened. How is he doing it?
It's not like you're trying to fuck the alien. Your career is fine.
He's working.
As long as you don't harass it. Look at you. Let me see your gray pussy.
Tom DeLonge can do what he wants, though, because he's Blink-182, so at the end of the day, people are kind of feel what Anthony feels about him, which is like, isn't this fucking idiot from Blink-182?
Yeah, why should I put any credence in what he says?
Whereas that's a hard one to discount, though. That video is pretty...
Neil deGrasse Tyson gets on TV, and he goes, hey, there's aliens. Everybody goes, yep, he's the physicist.
There must be aliens.
Tom DeLonge, he's doing a cool thing. He's working with the Pentagon. If you guys get a second, check out him on Joe Rogan.
What song do they do? The Pentagon.
We're only five-sided.
Fucking geometry.
Yeah, fuck yeah. We're not a hexagon.
Rich, you don't like that shit, right?
I love it.
You do?
Yeah,
big fan. Tish, tish.
It's fun, right?
The Christmas episode is coming up.
Oh, yes.
Next week.
Yes.
It's a barn burner.
Don't want to give away any of the twists and turns in that episode.
No.
It was fun.
A lot of singing.
I can't even. That was fucking hilarious. Chip's a maniac. Did have a lot of fun. Lenny Marcus, too.
Oh, yeah.
A Jew there on Christmas.
Yes.
Oh. A lonely Jew.
And that much.
Yeah.
Like Stan.
Like Rich. Rich isn't really practicing Jew.
No.
You have a tree in the house.
Well, it's not for Christmas me. It's for a kid and my, you know, not even my wife is an atheist. So.
It's in your house, though. What are you going to do?
Did she become an atheist after the wedding?
Yeah, sure.
He couldn't exist.
There is no God.
Atheists can have Christmas trees. It's not a holiday tree. Is not a religious symbol.
Yeah, it's a holiday tree.
Please.
It is a religious symbol.
The name Christ is right in the goddamn word.
We're trying to put the Christ back in Christmas. It's a holiday tree.
It's a Christmas tree. Trump bringing back Christmas with a vengeance.
Europe.
Yeah. Nobody's taking
it away.
Had a lot
of Christmas.
No, I'm not. I'm sitting.
Fuck yeah.
Europe.
What else?
You see Bill O'Reilly tweeting about his shirt sizes last night?
Oh. Well, shirt in quotes. I'm an extra large.
Where was he doing it? From a restaurant in New York on Facebook?
I get it. What?
Another man you won't see. Another person you won't see anymore. Poor Bill. Online. How's selling his books going? Oh. Killing my career. You should put out that book now.
Is he doing as well as he was now with his own site?
No. Yeah, Bill O'Reilly. Okay,
he tweeted out. He just said like it said something to the effect of, "Oh, here's the tip of the day. Many clothing companies have stealthily cut back on material, so order your stuff one size larger than you are. I'm 6'4", 210, and an XL used to do it. Not anymore. Now double XL." A lot of people took that to mean that Bill O'Reilly doesn't realize he's just gotten fatter.
He's gotten fatter and that he's sitting at home not working.
Right, right.
Or is he just fishing for people to send him free suits?
I'm a double X.
By the way.
That's pretty good.
Do you think, but hold on, how many of you, you know what? That fucking last video, maybe it's not what he used to do. Almost 630,000 views on a video that he put up. It's October 30th. Okay.
I'm not saying the guy doesn't have a following, that's for sure. That's
maybe he'll get a cable show.
Aren't they doing a new network with him and fucking Steven Crowder? Isn't it some new thing they were talking about or no?
No, CRT. What is it? CRT.
Is it conservative something? Something like I heard Gavin and
yeah, Gavin's on there. Crowder's on there. Yeah, yeah. They got a
network.
They got a network going.
Mm. Have they started it yet? Are they still?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Okay, I didn't even know.
That's going. I just did an interview with a Gavin yesterday.
Where's he based out of? New York?
Yeah. I did an interview with him about the Saturday Night Fever, as a matter of fact. You brought that up earlier. The fact that it's so racist against Italians, and some guy wrote an article about how terrible it is. And he asked me, you know, what do you think of this, being, you know, a WOP, as you are? And I'm like, I don't care. Like, most people, if they see something like that, they don't give a shit. Like, I found it funny that they're sitting around, you know, he touches my hair. Don't touch my head. Like, I find that shit funny. And it's like, well, it's stereotypical. No one talks like that. Now you're a cunt. Yeah. You know, all that shit. Like, no one would talk like that.
Right.
But I've known some real fucking guineas that talk like that. Yeah.
Tip of the day. I like a good tip of the day.
Oh.
Yeah, in your mouth.
He does tips of the day.
But again, he does have a following.
Yeah.
He does have a following.
He's also a little bigger than he used to be.
He's
fatter.
He's a double.
But he's getting
XL
like 9,000 likes. Not that that's everything. 2,600 retweets. That's some. That's at least
everybody's making fun of him.
Are they?
His tweet went. Yeah, that's why I brought the tweet up.
Oh, okay.
Everybody was mocking him.
It went viral. Funny.
It did go viral.
I mean, it would be awful if he didn't get any likes or retweets. That'd be fucking embarrassing. At least some people are paying attention. Hmm. Well, awful.
Why would you continue to tweet if you weren't getting likes and retweets?
I wouldn't.
You wouldn't.
No.
Me neither.
Chip gets likes and retweets.
He does?
Yes, he does.
Based on what?
Just people's humor.
Oh, humor?
Yeah, it's humor. Oh.
I hate unpacking dress shirts out of the package because it's just like, I don't understand why they're packaged like that.
With the pins?
It's always pins.
Can you put them on
right
after?
There's like brackets in there and clips now and plastic. Under the collars, the cardboard thing and then the plastic thing in the front.
Oh,
Did you ever notice?
Let me tell you something.
No, I'd rather do Kramer's act.
As far as shirts go, I've dedicated my life to figuring out how I can find a dress shirt that I can wear without tucking it in. They're either too long or they're too...
You know something? Easier said than done.
He just runs to the... There's a company called Untuck It. Thanks. Thanks, Dan.
I was going to play with this, Sam.
I know. I was going for
a... I was going to mix it up a little.
Pitch the commercials on Fox News all the time. I can't
hear my soundboard.
Do the Untuck It thing.
Oh, no. You can't.
I'm not sure why.
You were going to play some sounds?
I played one for his comment. Thank you,
Ron. I didn't hear it either.
No, it's not.
Is it on?
Oh, breakfast.
Pot it up.
Sam, breakfast. Is it what?
Oh, no toast again. Oh, no, I'm kidding. Of course. Thank you.
All right, it's for me.
You stupid fucking cunt.
Okay, I am.
That is a good one. Just play any clip.
Yeah, we just play Italian.
That's fun,
I
right?
love when you on the soundboard. You're so good.
Oh, it's just terrible when...
What?
Oh, I'd be crap. Yeah, and that would happen.
This your house, boy. Defend your house.
You be playing.
Fight hard. Keep going.
You're just pressing buttons.
How long will it last?
So you'd be playing
sounds?
There's
no sense to it. Like, I would like to play the sounds.
Sorry to interrupt.
That's good. See, that worked.
Yeah.
And you try to play sound, and then, you know, maybe other people with soundboards would start that needed to have a soundboard. We're just stomping on the, you know, like a child.
Right.
A xylophone.
Oh, wow.
Ah.
Like one of those like fake drum sets when you realize the cymbal makes a sound when you smack it.
Right.
And like my 10-month-old would just go fucking crazy.
Oh
just
my
hitting the
God.
Thing.
10 months?
He's 10 months.
Wow.
Yeah.
What are you going to do for the big 1 year? Big party?
Yeah, big boy, Hats. Too. Big kid.
He is a big kid.
Big kid? Yeah.
He's a big kid.
Wow.
Yeah.
How's grandma? Is she just like beside herself?
She's a
in
fan.
In love. Yeah, the whole thing.
Is she hugging him a lot and spoiling him?
She does like to hug him, yeah.
First haircut, keep the hair?
I don't know.
First shit they have frozen. It's in a diaper.
She asked us to send her the first box of the first year of diapers. So we've been collecting them.
That's
good.
Nice.
We've been collecting them for her.
Yeah,
for
she's gonna, and she's going to crush them the way you do a fucking car in a junkyard, and then she's going to make herself a fucking bonnet.
She actually
wants
to make
a 1 year shit duty bonnet.
She wants to make it like you know popcorn chains around the Christmas tree.
Oh,
she wants to make it with
this.
all the diapers.
Yes, and put them all over the house.
Yeah, that's
little
right.
Little heavy gifts.
I can't stand the popcorn fucking
what?
Garland.
Let me tell you something.
People make on the tree.
I don't
it's
like it.
2017. You could get fucking lights for the tree that are like lasers shooting out your ass, and they fucking still threading a needle and thread through popcorn
for 10 years
get 3 feet of fucking popcorn.
For the last 34 years,
yeah,
my mother pops a thing of popcorn.
Oh my God.
With a popcorn popper, not microwave.
Right.
Then gets a thing of cranberries.
Oh.
Takes her needle.
Great.
Takes her thread and spends her evenings while she's watching her programs.
All right, that's
making
that's,
her popcorn
that's,
I'm and cranberry.
Glad Laura Ingalls, popcorn. Your mom Laura Ingalls has a good fucking time.
Your mom makes cranberry popcorn stuff.
Yeah, for the treats.
I hope
every
bugs
other,
get
every
it.
Other one.
I hope you get fruit
cranberry,
flies.
Popcorn,
that's right.
You got to be.
Hey, Mark Norman. Hey, Mark Norman. Hey.
We're just about Mark to break. Mark. We're going to take our first break.
Breakfast.
Wow.
Yeah, we have to eat breakfast after we have a lot of reads today.
Can I play a controversial record for Christmas?
Well, not yet. I mean,
oh, Jesus.
Yeah, you have to play us into break. Travis, give Dennis a good 17 minutes to play us into break.
The house next door to me? No, that's
so
controversial.
Where are you going to be this weekend, Norton?
I'm not working.
Oh. Nice.
Just relaxing.
Weekend off.
Yeah, probably on the West Coast.
How about you, Mr. Voss? Where are you working?
I'm glad you brought it up. This weekend I'm at the Hartford Funny Bone, and March 29th,
yes.
Morristown Theater, March 29th. And now if you're a listener on Riotcast and My Wife Hates Me, we are also on Patreon.com.
Nice. Oh, yeah, Patreon. Do you do extra stuff for them?
Yes, we do an extra podcast, you know, a bonus one we put up. There's, you know, videos and see, I did a podcast with my daughter. We did a 25-minute podcast.
Oh, that's cool.
You know, I had to have someone smart on it. And, you know.
And people donate and stuff.
Yeah, well, I don't know. We just started doing it, you know. You
got to milk these fans. Got to get that money out of their pocket.
No, because we've been doing podcasts for 6 years. We don't.
Yeah, that's not crazy. I mean, doing Chip. I make
teasing.
Very, very little doing Chip. Like, it's just
wait, that's you?
No, I produce it.
Oh, jeez.
I produce it.
About to say.
No. I'm behind the scenes.
All right.
Realize.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll take a break. Anthony's got Voss on today, right?
Yes. Rich Voss finishing out the week of hosting. No, we do that tomorrow. We actually have another show tomorrow.
It's been fun.
It is Wednesday. I thought it was Thursday.
Suckers.
Yeah. Rich Voss, my co-host, while Artie Lang is vacationing.
On assignment.
On assignment.
Wow. Hey, Compound Media.
Big drop off.
Hey, Dennis Falcone, why is Chris the teacher blocked from your Twitter account? He says, I never tweeted Denny and I'm blocked.
No,
what's up with that?
He wouldn't be blocked.
Yeah, he says he's blocked.
No,
fuck him.
There's a fake Twitter going out there.
No.
That never happened.
Wow. That happens from time to time. No, Chris,
scoundrels. Never happened.
I'll check your Chris.
They make sure. They make sure that there's no fake accounts.
It's all very regimented.
Right.
I almost have 1,600 blocked. I can't wait to hit 1,600.
It's more than followers.
I know. Do you think I know you were going to say that?
All right. Hey, I'm at Mohegan Sun New Year's co-headlining with TJ Miller, so it's just me now.
Oh, shit. Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, TJ, man. You know, but
that's a bitch. He handled it great.
But
did he?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, I didn't notice.
The girl said... He's
talking about what he did to the girl.
Yeah.
With the beer bottle.
Did the girl say that he goes, I thought you were into it. Like, that, if you're gonna, like, that's the part about being in a fucking, like, spanking and shit like that.
And punching in the face.
But it was a punch or a hard slap. I mean, I don't know what that was.
And it's college.
But you gotta make sure the other person's into it. And I had to fucking... I was an adult, and I had a girl tell me, I want you to fucking slap me. I had a weird one. That's why I'll never not do that without really talking. You know, they have to tell you.
Also, she was an improviser. You got to go with it.
Yeah, yeah. You know. She should have known when she saw a poster Fatty Arbuckle on his wall. That's going back a ways, people.
Yeah.
He killed a girl with a Coke bottle.
Yeah. Did he kill her or just put her in a pussy?
I think he ripped her fucking uterus out.
He
pink socked her with a Coke bottle or something. Wow. He was just trying to keep the soda cold in a cozy.
It's a bad place to keep something cold. It's pretty warm in there. That's a good point.
Denny, are you
going to
play us out of the break, or are you just going to sit over there and do what you're doing?
People have complained about this song being played this season with what's going on with all the sexual harassment stuff.
I know which one this is.
Is it?
I know which.
If I turn Denny's mic off, that won't turn off his thing, right?
No.
Okay.
Jingle
good.
Bells.
Jingle bells?
No. I'm good. Oh well. Some people said that's racist, but I am going to go with. You want me to say?
I think I know.
I think I know
what
too.
What is it?
I saw Mommy and Daddy doing Scat by the Christmas Tree.
I would say, Baby, It's Cold Outside.
That's what I was going to say.
Yeah.
Good
right.
guess.
We'll be right back with our big Christmas extravaganza.
Oh God.
I really can't stay. But Baby, It's Cold Outside.
5 o'clock.
What about it?
Cool time.
Well, it's about to get even cooler. If you order by 5 p.m. Eastern Time today with free shipping, it's guaranteed. And Sam Roberts. Yeah. See, Rich, we do Christmas with a little edge.
Yeah.
You hear that guitar edge?
Yeah.
This is edgy. Yeah. That's great.
How do you like that, you Jew?
We take our Christmas caroling with a little rock and roll.
That's right. Yeah. It's fun, but, you know, we kind of... I ran out of things to say.
Okay. You didn't have to start.
I know. I thought I had something.
I didn't. Putting the Christ back in Christmas here on Jim Norton and Sam Roberts.
You're a good dancer.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, he really moves those hips. He really moves those square hips.
Just something to get everybody in the spirit.
Sure.
Yeah.
This is when you don't hear that much, though. I think there's like 10 Christmas songs. Whenever you go anywhere,
too
like
many.
When I go in the building, the lobby is playing. Is that,
too many
but
you.
It's like there's 10 songs and then there's 80 versions of each song by various artists.
That's true. There's a Mariah Carey.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
So I'm Dreaming of a White Christmas. And
yeah, you are.
You know, well.
And spring and fall.
Yeah.
What Hanukkah day are we on?
There's only a few. I think we're great done. Christmas.
Oh, is that over?
I don't know.
All right.
Oh, no.
You don't keep a menorah at the house?
I hate this. Fucking sleeves.
La, 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 la. It's good, right?
I don't know this guy.
What do you think so far?
It's a little weird.
Everyone fucking was crowing about this
shit. Hey, we're vibing, man.
Yeah. You know, it's so cool. It's... No, it's not. It's depressing dirge. Listen to this shit. I like to
drink a little. Sorry, somebody's gotta get in touch with your emotions.
I like to fuck another queer. I like to drink another beer.
Stop stealing my lines.
Oh.
Third grade.
Yeah, this is very good.
Yeah.
It's nice.
What no, it's
this?
Not.
It's his sleeves.
It's some guy and he...
You don't like it, Mark?
I don't know. It's weird.
It's depressing.
This is Christmas?
Yeah, exactly. Thank you.
Oh, yeah. This sucks.
Finally.
Christmas.
Finally, somebody concurs.
Oh, this is my favorite. Holy night.
Oh.
Stinks.
What?
It's nice. Hang on. It's going to pick up
right,
again.
Wait, it picks out a
lot.
I was feeling pretty good. So la 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 la. Taking my time.
I love this part. And it goes.
Boom. Down
nope.
In the la la.
In the la la. It doesn't make sense.
There it is. There's the kick. Decking all the halls.
Oh.
Yeah.
Making my way to the la 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 la. Where? What?
Wait.
Get out of here.
Maybe that's like la 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 is code for Chicken Hawk Party.
Soda Pop Club.
Yeah.
Soda Pop Club.
Yeah. Yeah.
Pizzagate. Yeah. Sleeves involved in Pizzagate.
Yeah. Pulled down his little trousers for la 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 la. Nuzzled his tiny little hiney la la. He cried into his pillow la la.
Cut a little guesser on my nose, la la. Kitten kill my heart on, fa la 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 la. Blood on the tip, fa la 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 la. Memories wiped out, fa la 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 la. Accuse me 30 years later, la 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 la.
Ooh, that was a remix.
Yeah. Oh, man. Life. That was real.
Yeah,
life.
It's amazing how you can spew out pedophilia lyrics so quickly.
Right?
It's really impressive. It's like it's in you.
Yeah, thank God for the dark web, la 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 la. Onion router, fa la 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 la. Tor browser, fa la 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 la. VPN blocker, fa la la la.
He sure does know a lot about the dark web.
It's an eight.
If somebody can't figure out his photos on his iPhone, you know a lot about how to browse on the dark web.
I just know the terms.
Yeah. You know? So you know the jargon.
Yeah. Bitcoin, keep us out of jail, fa la la la.
Now that's a carol.
Yeah, yeah. I'm not a fan of the Sleeves Christmas song.
Mariah Carey, though, is one person who, within recent years, was able to actually put out an original Christmas song that became a real Christmas song.
Oh, yeah. It's Christmas and I'm fatter than I used to be. That's a nice one.
So did Wham. Wham, Last Christmas.
What was their song?
That was like... That
he's
was,
dead.
No, that was the
he's
same
dead.
Time. That was
he's
the,
dead.
That was
dead.
The
he's dead.
Wham and Mariah Carey behind. Were not the same time.
Yes, they were.
No.
Uh-oh. Google
are
it.
Are you fucking crazy?
Wow.
I'm crazy like a fox.
Mariah Carey wasn't even singing in the
80s. He was 84, I think.
Yeah.
Big
Mariah
difference.
Mariah Carey was like 10 in 1984. Yay.
Hers was like in the 90s.
Exactly. So two different decades, that is.
Yeah, but it was like,
He doesn't like when you tell him he's wrong with his music.
Tell me, motherfucker, you tell me my business.
Yeah. Tell me my fucking business.
Yeah, don't fuck with him. He's got two headphones.
Exactly.
We got any Wham over there for the boys?
I got a little Wham for you. Last Christmas.
He's chipping for his music.
What's going on?
He's got to change the vinyl, folks.
So he's just singing it.
A stack of records.
It's not on.
It's on.
Oh.
Dennis is good with the improv, though. He's like, all right, you're not going to turn my turntables on. I'll sing the songs.
I wish he was DJing in Brazil. Oh, did that guy get clunked on the head?
Did they? I saw the video. Did they actually see him get hit, or just the whole thing fall
down? The whole thing falls down, yeah. Apparently he was on there, though, and got hit.
Really bad.
There was a lot of wind and rain, and the whole stage thing came down on top of...
He's no longer with us. We'll have to pay our respect.
DJ Caleb.
I didn't see that.
We'll have to pay our,
not Caleb. Caleb. It's a different guy, right?
We'll have to pay our respect to him.
Yeah. A respect, a single respect.
Was this DJ really famous? Was he a big DJ? Caleb or no?
Not in the States, anyway.
Was it the guy with the mouse head?
No, I like him.
Was it the gentleman with the two motorcycle helmets?
He's called Dead Mouse, ironically enough.
Yes.
All those DJs that wear those ridiculous helmets would have been safe.
That's a good point.
Oh, yeah.
They all would have been fine.
Can you imagine that, though? I mean, you're DJing and it's windy. He must have been famous. There was a lot of people that...
Wear a hat.
You look like fucking Elmer Dudd.
Let me show you how cool this is.
How cool it is.
The DJ is taking the headphones off to turn hats on.
Oh, that's great.
It's good.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, exactly. It's called Lil Denny on his way for chemo.
Yes.
Sick Lil Denny. We found a lump in his hiney.
Oh, look at that.
He's got ear flaps, too.
He should have a tin lunchbox.
Do you have ear flaps on that?
Yeah.
Oof. Thanks. Wait, let me hear what's the Mariah Carey one? Is that good?
Yeah, I got it.
Oh, yeah. Mariah Carey's classic.
I think she stinks.
It came out just the same time as Wham.
She was hot in her day, though.
Yeah. Tommy Mottola ruined her.
It was one day in 95. She had these roller skates on and short shorts. It was pretty amazing.
Wow.
Yeah, give it a Google.
Fantasy. Mm.
What's this called?
Around that time.
Yes.
Right? All I Want
Smoking
for Christmas.
Hot.
1984, All I Want for Christmas, Mariah Carey.
Hers was later,
don't
but
try
I was
to make,
like
Sam,
last.
Don't try to make it sound cool that you know all the Mariah Carey songs.
Exactly.
She's at the Beacon.
Last generation. Is what I mean.
Yeah.
It's not the same decade.
They were 8 years apart.
It is a big song.
Totally different.
Right. But within 10 years, you would say it's around the same time.
Yeah, 8 years. That's old enough to get plowed.
Oh, yeah, this one.
You know this one.
Oh, her with her vocal aerobics.
Do you like her?
She's pretty thick.
I don't mind Mariah Carey.
I don't either. No. You like that?
No. I'm into that, yeah. Look at that. Come on. Yeah. What's the problem?
That's back in the day.
That's the Heartbreaker era.
Ugh. She's curvaceous.
She is sexy, man. Oh, she was.
But she's out of her mind crazy. That's
I don't
not
care.
Bad.
Oh, come on. Her hips and Roger her.
Yeah, I'm not hanging out. Just go to the roller skates if you can find it. It's quite an image.
Yes.
Do you like her? No. The one. That's terrible.
Anthony, do you like her music?
No. No.
No, go down.
Oh,
we're not going to find it.
That's at Rye Playland, where that photo was taken, because that's where they did this video for Fantasy.
Oh, yeah, where she's in the roller coaster?
You know where Rye Playland is, right?
In Rye Beach, Westchester.
Westchester, the best Chester.
Right. Oh, there she is.
That's right.
Jeez, big enough knee pads or what?
I know. Just in case she falls, right?
That looks silly.
I don't find that.
Really?
No, well, you like dudes.
Because there's a vagina.
Oh,
yeah,
like guys. Man. Wow,
she looks terrible there.
Yeah, that was bad. Jesus, cans are really mushed.
What's going on? Her nip is popping out. Or what's going on there?
She still get it.
She really plumped. Yeah. She like pulled a Val Kilmer.
Wow.
She did.
They look fake, though. You can see where the fake are. They look fake.
So now we're just playing Mariah Carey tunes.
We are.
Right. Tommy Mottola comes in whipped cream.
Just... Dallas got his privileges taken away.
Yeah, he did. She's a wide lady.
Yeah, she looked good. Slim.
You're right, Mark.
You're
kind of slimmer.
I don't mind it.
I don't mind it,
Mark.
She's a little wide, but yeah, it's fun.
Yeah, for some reason, you know, that's all the rave. Everybody's got to think fat ass girls are hot.
I like a little juicy rump.
Are you kidding me?
I don't mind that, but there are some girls legitimately just big fat ass. That's a big fat ass, and it's like, ooh, yeah, get out of here.
And they have
jealous.
A show on
terrible.
E.
You're just jealous.
Yeah, I don't like big fat.
Oh, like a Denny's playing
Fat Bottom
songs
girls.
That make sense with what we're talking about.
Well, there you go. I feel like we've done this bit before.
No, this is good.
Yeah, I know this is good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. This is the best Christmas party I've ever been to.
This is not bad.
It's good. Yeah,
breakfast, coffee.
We don't need one more. I knew it was going to be this one. Like, this is the obvious, like, no more.
All right, Denny.
This party is only second to Billy Bat's homecoming.
Sorry, I'm not your floor, Henry.
You know,
yeah.
We got big my party. We got big best of specials coming up starting next week all through the end of 2017.
Wow. Yes, we do.
Yes, it's the top 20 of minutes. 2017.
So it's actually two of them
Dennis,
played 10 times each.
20 minutes.
And you guys, did the minutes joke twice in a row.
Yeah, but you got to let me hear it.
How do you guys only have off, or you have off like now Thursday and Friday?
For this week.
We just did it.
Like you just decided.
We're the fucking
half we're
week.
Taking time off because Christmas is a weird. We don't want to do more than a week off for Christmas.
What are you talking like? Yeah. You're sitting there going like, yeah. Why don't you be like a normal person and work 4 days a week?
Well,
yeah.
I would think you'd do it till Friday and then take like next week or something.
No, we want it more than a week though.
We could do next week.
Oh, whoa, wow! Christmas. Look at you guys.
Some people are off this week too.
Oh,
yeah.
Hmm.
No, I get Christmas and in between
company.
Christmas and New Year's. Yeah, that's all I get.
You don't have vacation day. You just do the show
in,
when you
I
want.
I have to put in for it.
Artie gets like
approved.
Artie gets 2 months.
Yeah, Artie's getting a very nice long Christmas break. Yeah.
I know of all the times though, right?
What are you talking about?
Sure, he'll have a white Christmas.
Oh, see?
Well, just to be in a rehab for Christmas. Who wants that? You want to be with family, friends, having a nog.
That's terrible. Right. I spent my birthday in rehab a couple of years ago.
Yeah, that worked.
I'm glad it
when
took.
I was there.
Yeah,
please.
So they give you
the coolest rehab ever.
If you spent your birthday in the Keebler Elf House, it would have helped you more.
I did. I had fun though. The people there were cool, and there was a pool.
Pool.
Yeah,
you have a pool in your house.
Big pool. It was like April down in Florida. It was nice and warm.
Every rehab's amazing. It's always like Malibu on a beach and shit.
Those are all bullshit rehab.
Oh, is that right?
Some of them might be. Look at them.
Like Harvey Weinstein is in a rehab.
That's all bullshit rehab. Good. Those are.
Listen, some of them might work. I mean,
anything works if you want it to work.
Yeah. Mine completely fucking worked.
Really?
It did. It got the paper signed to the judge. That fucking worked.
There you go.
I spoke at a place in L.A.
Oh,
where the fucking
Were they wearing Gallagher's stuff?
Duvetyn.
Dirt bottoms were like because they're
plump and delicious.
But, you know what I mean? It's just it's not reality.
Why? That's not true. Their bottoms might be bottoms for them.
I'm talking millionaire.
So what? Nobody's ever an addict enough for Voss.
I know. Just because you suck dicks.
That's not true.
You don't know the struggle.
Voss. No,
I know.
Well, I do know the struggle. But yeah. No, that's not true. That's not true. I know people that
How do you know what their bottoms were? How do you know that they didn't have like violent outbreaks or fucking divorces or the kids that live with their mother now?
Yeah.
Okay.
You giving them advice is a bottom.
Exactly. You're their speaker. How fucking good do you think things were?
Right. It's all relative, though. Different bottoms for different people.
That's true. But when you have millions, a lot of the bottoms are financial. And you can't get fucking
It's not all
drugs.
About money, hands.
No, and you can't get the drugs, so you got to do whatever you got to do to get the drugs. You see, but when you got tons of fucking money.
You do more drugs. Yeah, Charlie Sheen's rich.
So you're saying you can't be that much of an addict if you're rich?
No, I'm saying it's not as, I think.
Rich is speaking exactly against what is typically the message.
Rich is an enemy to recovery.
No, I'm thinking.
Yes,
no,
you
I'm
are.
Saying
I've seen bottles say more valuable things about recovery.
So is TJ Miller.
I forget it. It's hard to say. No.
What
Why?
Do you think?
I'm done. I don't want to talk about recovery. At a Christmas party.
If you're rich,
you have no problems.
You're not really addicted.
I'm saying you have problems. No, I didn't say.
Yes, I know people that are rich that are just stupid.
No fixing that.
Nope.
Let me kind of.
Yeah. But it's weird. The sex therapy. At a rehab, the sex rehab.
Right. Yes.
How does that work?
That's. I think that's bullshit.
Well, that's just for the judge. That's different. That's different.
Some people are addicted to.
When you look at what you've done, like I'm not. I haven't done anything in quite a while, and I'm not even jerking off as much. And I think you realize the fucking. It's hard, man. Like how much you depended on that shit.
Yeah, I think sex rehab is used a lot more even than. Any other rehab as far as an excuse?
It could be, sure.
I think a lot of that, like, oh, harassment, this, well, he's going off to a rehab.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
He cheated on his wife.
Right.
Hey, honey, I'm an addict. I got to go to.
Yeah.
Yeah. It can work, maybe. I don't know. I don't know as much about the sexual stuff. I probably should.
I mean, if you put, you know, the same theory behind, you know, stopping one day at a time, it's the same with sex.
No, sex is different, though, because there's different, what do they call it? You have different bottom lines. Like, some people, like, masturbation is okay. A little porn is okay, but the problem was pay for sex. It all depends on what your problem. You can't just totally cut sex out.
But I... Yeah, obviously, what I heard that people that go to Sex Anonymous or whatever, they can't jerk off.
That's some places, yeah, but I mean, I love tugging my dick. I ain't been doing it in a while.
Jim likes to fuck. He's got a fucking problem.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
If it interferes with your life, it is a problem.
Yeah, it does.
And if how do they do that in rehab? How do they, like... Like just, obviously they could do the best job they can to keep booze and drugs out of a rehab, but if you're in a sex rehab, shower you just jack off.
Yeah, your dick's attached to you.
Right. You can't take your dick.
I can't do music follows the conversation.
Why? It's good.
It's not good.
What if there's a hot girl in there? You obviously.
That's.
Wow. Well, he's a man.
Wow. Oh man, this hot chick is gonna.
I've never heard a gay guy say anything as not straight as that. But what if there's a hot chick in town? Dick sucker.
Thanks, Paul Lynn.
Guys, I can't do that. It might be some punani.
I can't turn down that piece of puss.
Oh, you had to ruin the flow.
We talking
about? I'll fuck her on her period. I don't care.
Yeah. I'm not. You, Anthony really doesn't care. You'll fuck on the rag, right?
Oh, yeah. It doesn't bother me.
You won't?
No. I want to talk. I won't even allow her to prepare my meals. Yeah. I'm like a Rastafarian. Sleep on the floor.
When I was dating, I did, but
I don't mind.
I got to think that if you're married for a while, that shit'll go away.
Stop it. She's sitting there and all that blood is just fucking flowing. No way.
But, and it's not coming out of her face.
I've done that. You grab a towel, throw it on the
bed. I just can't do it. I'm a little squeamish.
That's it. I'm a little squeamish.
I am. Yeah, I can't. Anything with blood, I can't do. I wish I was better at that.
What if you're underwater and somebody's making you blow him while he pisses in your mouth?
Hey, it's not blood.
It's true.
It's just a dick and some tinkle. I didn't, you know.
What about a bris?
I've been to a bris. They're like, you're not allowed to do that thing. I'm like, oh, sorry.
So you won't turn around and see the blood on him?
No, it's usually on me.
Yeah, that doesn't bother me that much.
Yeah, it's amazing. Really? Florentine's like that, too. I can't do it.
Good man.
Mm. When I was a kid, I had a porn VHS, and a black guy.
You were in a what?
I was in a snuff. And this black guy was banging a white gal in the the tuchus. And there was a just a drop of blood ran down his dong. It was brutal. It was too much.
And what did you? And then he kept yelling. Why are you yelling? I'll suck it off.
like Demi Moore's tear in Ghost.
Yes.
Yeah. Slowly dripping down.
Yeah, a bloody tear falls off his helmet onto his socks. Black guys always fuck with their socks.
Yes,
on.
He had socks on.
What is that about?
I don't know.
It's just a different culture, man.
Ashy feet.
Oh, ashy. You think maybe, that's
ashy feet?
Yeah. Interesting.
I never heard that.
But if there's a hot chick there, I guess you just deal with it.
Yeah,
she was hot chicks in the world.
She was a pro. She kept going.
Did you see that that guy that does the Bill Burr impression?
I didn't watch it. I know that guy.
Was he good? You know that guy?
Yeah, he's good.
I was watching it last night. Someone sent it to me. It is the guy.
Oh, yeah, I know him.
Oh, fucking Chip.
Okay.
Hey, what's up?
Anymore.
I got red hair.
That's spot on.
It's not bad.
This guy does a really good job.
That's at my show, Shtick or Treat. I'd see him walk. There you go. This kid's good.
No, that's Mark Norman on YouTube.
Wait, but I wanted to see the one where he does
the master class.
The master class, yeah. Find the Bill Burr.
That's the first one on the right.
Teaches comedy. Yeah, up top, right there. Yeah.
Bill Burr master class.
All right, this is Tyler Fisher.
All right, is there a director? Is someone gonna yell action? Do I have to fucking yell action? Fucking action! We're doing this on a fucking Monday! Hi, I'm comedian Bill Burr, and this is my comedy masterclass.
It's good. Really good.
He sounds like Bill, man.
It gets better.
6-week comedy course. Does that say 6 weeks? You think you could learn comedy in 6 fucking weeks? Try 30 fucking years, all right? Being lonely, fucking broke, you got no girlfriend, you got nothing. My freaking wife, you know, she dragged me into this crap. Oh, Bill, yo, you need to start doing video. Oh,
that's dead on.
That's right.
Yelling at kids in public. Gang, 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 gang. What fucking time this is. Bro, if you have a question, just fucking yell it. And this isn't fucking 5th grade, okay? I'm not going to fucking hit you.
He's even sitting like Bill.
Yeah, he really.
So when you first take
studied
the stage,
Bill,
is it better
I guess.
To take the microphone out of the stand, or should I move the stand closer?
Taking
to
notes.
Me?
Is it better to take the fucking microphone? Are you fucking kidding me with that shit? How about be fucking funny? All right. Fuck. You fucking hold it like a man, not like a goddamn daffodil.
Hey, watch.
Oh yeah, give it a watch at home.
Bill.
That's you good. No, that's a good job.
Yeah.
You do you do, Bill?
Fuck yeah.
Can we see it?
Just go up there and act like you're fucking angry or something.
Solid.
It sounds like really Chip. Good, Chip. Yeah. It sounds a lot like Chip Chipperson.
That's a good Bill Burr.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, funny guy.
They asked me to teach a masterclass.
Who?
On radio.
Ah.
Oh, no.
They did on radio.
They did?
Yeah.
How would you, what That's would you possibly nice. Teach?
Just how to do radio. I'd be funny on the radio. I'd be off the cuff.
I'd accidentally mute people.
Yeah, boom. I know how to be funny off the cuff.
You do?
Yeah.
You
what's that?
Nothing.
I know he said.
Nothing.
What did you say, Rich?
I didn't mean to cut you off because you were on a roll. Go ahead.
No, I'm just saying that's a master class of radio. You had to be off the cuff and boom, fire.
Oh, fire what?
Fire jokes.
Like what?
Witticisms.
Witticisms.
Whatever that's... it is. Hey, both of you guys got button-up shirts. What did you, come together in the morning?
Ew.
Ew. It's a good base to work from.
It is, mm-hmm. Right? The outfits.
Right there.
We got it at separate times.
Then you get to funny at some point later.
Yeah. Hey, your shirt's on. Hey, what did somebody not teach you how to button that thing?
Yeah. It's a good one. It's solid.
Is it a button show?
Yeah.
Is it just radio show about buttons?
Buttons.
Button radio?
Buttons.
Button?
Yeah. What does your shirt say? Velveeta room, cheesy. Say boom. Incorporate
wow.
what's in the room.
That's good. You,
that's actually
use
really great.
The material in the room.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And wait for your boss to go on vacation.
Yes.
I know what you're saying.
Boss right.
That's right. And play your way onto the team. If the regular third baseman decides that he can just sleep all through spring training, you play your way onto the team.
I love it. Masterclass.
I'm going to do it.
Where at Rutgers?
Terrible. Oh, I mean, we're all winding down and you just bring some Rutgers.
I'm where are you doing it at?
No, it's not real. It's just a joke. Just kidding.
Oh, I thought he was offered it.
No, he was just kidding. Just a little
I
bit.
I could see him being offered it.
What are you talking about?
No, his joke bombed so horribly.
No, it wasn't.
Shut up.
Yes, it was. No, it wasn't.
I swear to God.
It was not.
It was not.
Is that what happens?
Talk into the mic, Rich. I won't believe you're that stupid.
When the joke bombs and then you make it seem like you were making a serious statement.
That's what he does.
I do it all the time.
Yes.
For an hour a night.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't mean it, guys. I'm serious. I just wanted to see what you'd say.
It's actually more of a one-man show than a comedy routine. It's just...
Again, I think that's what Michael Richards tried to do that night.
That was very funny.
No, but I'm making a statement
it's
now.
It's just a word.
Yeah. It's a word. Don't we know that a word is very... Fuck, I'm done. I'm so done.
It's performance art.
Performance art.
Boy, did he fuck up.
Oh, that was bad. The Dave Chappelle line was so great about that. He goes, that's when I learned I was more of a comedian than a black guy, because I watched it, I went, whew, that nigga having a bad set.
I said something similar.
Oh my god.
Oh boy. You really are back there.
Yeah. Is that in the seminar?
Yeah, I was saying something like that.
Yeah.
Did you,
I can't.
Did you hear the Insane Clown Posse has lost their appeal?
Yes, it's a gang.
The Juggalos.
Yes!
It's a posse, really.
The Juggalos are still going to be classified as a gang.
Why?
That's not fair.
Well, they said that the memo didn't hurt ICP. What they said was
the Juggalos.
No. ICP, they wanted the Juggalos. In a memo, they had said that they were a gang, and Insane Clown Posse said that hurts us, and the judge was saying that the memo didn't do anything to hurt them, so they didn't have to declassify
them. So Jimmy said when he was underwater in the pool, ICP. See, because.
I taste.
What I have to guess.
Yeah.
I mean, I can't imagine that a bunch of guys that are just fans of a band and they go, oh, that's a gang.
They're juggalettes.
Crystal
too.
Meth. Yeah. They must be so heavily into crystal meth.
What?
That it's a gang.
The Burn and Emberettes are a gang.
Who would want to be part of that? Emberettes.
They're just a bunch of guys and girls. They like to wear face paint. Mm-hmm. They like to jerk off in people's macaroni.
What's that now?
Juggalos.
I didn't know that was a part of it.
Well, have you never heard the song, What is a Juggalo?
No, I haven't.
The lyric says, I mean, Troy, am I wrong?
No, you're 100% correct.
They're not.
What?
A Juggalo is not a phony. He'll come in your house and bust a nut in your macaroni.
Wow, that's like a Norton lyric.
Yeah, it sure is. No, then what, you all eat the macaroni.
If macaroni means your asshole.
Little boy's asshole.
Yeah, that's, it's been pretty well clarified what a Juggalo is, and it's not a gang member.
Fans, I would think it's got to be something. Even GTA 5 knew to put to make him the meth dealers.
Yeah.
Juggalos.
Well, look, there are going to be some Juggalos that like drugs.
Yeah.
I'm sure of that.
Sure.
Yeah. But there are probably some like people who like the Eagles that use drugs.
Of course.
Right?
That's true. But Eagles fans aren't classified as a gang.
That's the problem. They should be.
They should be.
Yeah, they're all outside. No, you know, new kid in town. There's a new kid in town.
That's a Johnny come lately.
Yeah, sure is.
Yeah.
Mm. You know what hotel they stay at?
Which one?
I can't figure that out.
Like, you don't know. Which one is it, Jim?
California.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, a bunch of desperados out there.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
She's a witchy woman.
That's right.
I hated that song. I
hate that song.
Witchy woman is terrible.
Witchy woman. Witchy woman.
I don't think it's right what they're doing to the Juggalos.
No, I don't either.
I don't get it.
It's bullshit. it's
They're not a gang. They're not a gang.
Somebody said, by the way, people were yelling chip lines in the fucking, when they went and saw that movie.
The disaster artist?
Yeah, somebody said that. I guess they were in a theater where somebody was yelling chip lines.
It's probably the person who called, trying to pat himself on the back.
Right.
I went to see the disaster artist. Nobody brought Chip up.
Nobody's where he went.
Oh. I guess we were in different theaters.
Yes, you were.
Travis, you seen the disaster artist?
No, I'm going to see it this weekend.
Oh, what a herb.
Cool.
Did you like? I thought it was okay. I wasn't crazy
about
it.
Well, I'm also like obsessed with The Room.
Okay.
Were you a big fan of The Room?
I saw it once drunk years ago, it wasn't, I didn't really connect.
Why didn't you love The Disaster Artist?
I thought it was a little cheesy. It's a lot of like, we're going to make it. We're going to LA. We're going to live our dream.
They definitely like Hollywooded up the story.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, it's a big Hollywood movie.
It's no Mickey Mouse stuff.
Why'd they Hollywood it up? You don't have
Because
to.
They want to win awards.
Mm. Yeah, but you still could.
No, because they want to win awards and they want to make a bunch of money. They don't just want to make like a movie that like me and their friends like because we like The Room. Like they want to make, you know, a mainstream movie that, and it's going to get nominated for something.
James Franco was amazing.
Right?
Yeah, that
he
was good.
Killed it. You know what's good is Lady Bird.
Oh, is that about Lyndon Baines Johnson and when he went away, who she'd fuck the gardener?
No.
It's a coming-of-age tale about a lady going off to college.
It's really good.
Yuck.
It's great.
Okay.
It's so good.
Really.
Who's in it? Who's in Lady Boyd?
Nobody big, really.
Why would you want to see it? Lady Boyd?
It's what?
You're in it?
Who's in that? Mia Sparrow?
Wait, hold on. Back.
Yes.
Sit back.
Yeah, here it comes.
I saw the trailer.
Robin Wright.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Wrong. Fuck right. Yeah.
Blue Jay Leno.
Did you?
Walter Pigeon.
Denny, go.
Walter Pigeon.
Oh, Walter Pigeon.
Right.
The Eagles.
Larry Bird.
Bird Yuma.
I saw the trailer for it and it looks
all right.
There you go.
It works.
The you know what brings it back.
It looks very much like another like look how quirky this teenager is. I wish, you know, like the writer.
It's good. It's heavy. A lot of emotion. A lot of heart.
I just feel like there's so many.
I hate those movies.
It's
movies.
Great.
Emotion and heart.
It's killer.
There's so many of those movies come out where the writer writes the person that they wish that they were in high school, but nobody's actually that cool or quirky or anything.
No, she's very unlikable.
Is she?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, is she pretty?
No.
She's a teenager.
I'm going to write a movie
high
about
school.
Glass Castle.
Should be pretty.
Good movie.
I'm not saying you fuck them.
Stop talking about the Glass
What's
Castle.
What's the Glass
boss?
Castle? What is
no, we already talked about this last time he was in. I don't want to talk about it again.
Great Woody movie. Harrelson?
He didn't know what it was.
Yes, I did. Great movie.
You see, Shape of Water?
No, I heard bad things.
Ooh.
What?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you heard from the wrong source.
Oh, you liked?
It was good.
I mean,
it wasn't like
time.
The greatest thing I ever
Guillermo's,
saw, but it was good.
Amazing.
Yeah, Guillermo del Toro.
What about Star Wars?
Joe Mackey did not like Star Wars.
Really?
We talked to him yesterday, and he really didn't like it.
He didn't like it.
Was there nudity? Is that why?
And he disrespected Travis for liking it.
Kevin Smith was on Facebook. He did a review of Star Wars. It was an hour and a half.
Ugh.
He was talking about the movie, and at certain parts, he actually started crying.
Oh. Kevin Smith
was crying. He's talking about one scene where Luke is in the Millennium Falcon, and R2-D2 rolls in, and he's like, oh, and he goes, and they were meeting again, like, and this was the little droid and him that started the whole, he goes, look, I was bawling in the theater, and I'm already getting worked up again, and he's crying! I felt terrible!
He's the Michael Moore of nerd movies.
But Kevin can talk, but he's a great talker.
Dude, an hour and a half, and I watched the whole thing. I wanted to see what the fuck it was.
What?
I did. Look, it was late.
I love Kevin Smith, so I can watch it.
Yeah, I do an hour-long monologue about pro wrestling every single week, so I can't really.
That is true.
Criticize Kevin.
That's true.
But you cry?
Do
you
cry? I don't cry. I don't cry.
Do you cry?
I don't. Usually not.
The listeners cry.
Yes,
they do.
I do hour monologues too.
About what? Politics?
Is it 11 o'clock?
Why?
Yeah, he cried a couple of times during the review.
That's a bit much. I cried.
I don't know what it is. Is it Is it that he's a dad, or is it that he's so fucking high?
Or he's getting older. Or getting sometimes older. That happens. I've gotten more sensitive as I've gotten older. It happens.
Have you?
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, haven't you?
There he is. Turn the volume.
Okay, all right. Yeah, let's
Oh, I can't watch this.
All right, which one is that?
We go. We got to put a towel down.
I know.
You got it over there, Troy?
I'm playing on my side.
No. Hang on.
Oh, shit, we ain't got no... We got no volume.
These are usually on.
Did you see the movie, Anthony?
I did see the Star Wars. Yes.
And?
It was okay. I had some issues with some of the thing, but, you know, it's Star Wars. What are you expecting?
Try it again, Troy.
Wind up behind very familiar head instead of ears. And this is another highlight of the movie for me because, again, it's very easy to put together. Anytime you let the old characters talk to each other, you got my full attention. And there he was, Yoda. And hats off to Ryan and the production folks for choosing the Yoda they chose. It was the Yoda who dies in Return of the Jedi. We've seen Yoda
in
the
prequels.
They've done Yoda as a version of puppets. Remember in the first in the
Yoda?
The Phantom Menace.
Fuck. Well, you had to know.
But Lucas thrown himself Yoda. What happened with Kylo Ren.
Luckily, I don't care.
Yoda.
Rich, you upset that you know Yoda's in the new Star Wars?
I don't care. Didn't they just come out with one recently with a black guy or something? How long?
That's a great description.
I would love to hear Rich's take.
I've never seen one, but didn't one just come out?
Billy
like
D. Williams?
Billy D. Williams.
Billy D.
Yes.
No, there is a
Rogue One came out a year ago.
The White Chick.
That was a great movie, Rogue One. It was really, really
Rogue
good.
One was really good. I think, that's one of the top
But
three.
Darth Vader's done in this one. Go fuck yourself,
He's,
Star Wars.
Well, they're trying
no
to...
No longer with us.
They're trying to make a new franchise, kind of, it doesn't always have to just be about Skywalker and Darth Vader and stuff. So they're kind of, this last movie kind of gives them the opportunity to move in a whole nother direction with other people that are part of the rebellion or the resistance. So it might not have anything to do with the characters we're familiar with.
Stop it with no Darth Vader.
You don't like no Darth
no,
Vader?
No, I don't.
The Rogue One, the end was great.
How, when he's running through, cutting people's heads off?
Yeah, that was pretty good.
I missed that.
And it was good. Like, everybody fucking dies.
You know they're
it's
all going to die.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
That's it.
Spoiler alert.
A little spoiler, but I think everybody knew that.
It was a year ago.
And it was a little part of the first episode, like a prequel to the first episode that we ever saw back in 77. I think they did a good job on that one.
I do too.
I didn't cry over it like fucking pissy pants Kevin Smith. Little pissy eyes Kevin Smith.
When's the last time you cried?
Oh, I can't even fucking tell you.
Maybe. Come on.
I can't even tell you.
He gets mad when he hears sleeves because there's somewhat of an emotion to it.
Oh, yeah. Disgust. That's the emotion.
Was it your dad died? You cried in 1995?
Oh, yeah. Probably 95.
What about when they buried the N-word?
He hopped in the coffin screaming like a mother.
Take me with you.
Yeah. Like Rose.
He was like,
my Jackie Jr.
Jackie Jr.'s mom. Anthony gets the phone call. He's already consoling because the N-word is sick.
Just drop the phone.
And he gets the phone. He knows his sister's in there. And she's like, it's dead. It's gone. Can you just hear Anthony in the background going, no!
Take me instead.
Oh, is that when Jackie Jr. died?
Jackie Jr.
Spoiler alert.
Yeah, another spoiler from
They had
years.
To kill him, right? Because he fucked up and robbed the card game and someone got shot. Is that what
he did? Yeah. It really went wrong, that card game knockover.
Who decided he had to be killed?
It was Ralph. Tony gave the choice to Ralph, but it wasn't much of a choice.
But Tony was trying to set Ralph up to not kill him so that Ralph would look bad.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
So they had to kill him even though he was the fucking son of his girlfriend, right? Ralph's girlfriend.
At the time, and then Ralph started dating Janice after that.
Yes. This is a good recap of 20-year-old TV.
I love it.
But I don't remember. How did they kill Jackie Jr.?
Shot in the back of the head.
So it was a quick one.
In the ghetto.
In the ghetto.
And they blamed it on drug dealers.
They always do.
Yeah, but it was, I think it was Vito, right?
He's been rambling the whole show.
He just mumbles back there.
He's just talking to himself.
He was talking to the computer while you were doing, like, another thing over there.
Somebody said shot in the back of the head, and Dennis starts saying, shot through the heart, and then he goes, I like that song.
Let's turn Dennis' music
back on. I like that song.
What's that?
Can we turn Dennis' music back on and see what he's got working on over there? Because I'm pretty sure he's been DJing the whole show silently.
You know, the music has been on very low. Now he's just starting it.
Oh,
it's Disco Star Wars.
He was just
back in the 70s.
Like, if he could just have, like, a soundtrack going.
Yeah.
But the fact that he has to change the song to what we're talking about is just annoying.
I know. I don't like changes.
Do you remember Disco Star Wars, Jimmy? When they would they put out a disco version of the Star Wars theme.
No.
And in the middle of it, R2, it starts talking.
Well, you know, the one thing that they did pull was the Christmas album they did. See if you could pull it up there.
The Christmas special.
The special.
No, there was an album that came out.
Well, I don't remember that. I just know that
there's Star Wars Christmas album.
There's the Star Wars Christmas special starring...
B. Arthur was in that?
B. Arthur! Yeah, B. Arthur was in it.
It was really funny. Good special. It wasn't long enough with Chewbacca's family, though.
That. Rumor has it, though, that George Lucas went out and just tried everything in his power to buy up every copy of this thing that was out there for a while. And then once the internet hit, he's like, yeah, I'm pretty much fucked.
It's like there's that porn.
Could do.
What was that porn they had to pull back because of the issue was underage?
Tracy Lords.
Yes.
She was dating Tom Byron back then,
Oh, yeah.
Tommy she was very hot. She was the biggest thing in porn. And then people found out she was 16. They had to yank all her old stuff.
Even bigger.
Wow.
Yeah, because she really looked 16 in those movies.
All right.
Did you ever see
giant
it?
Giant jugs.
Yeah, yeah. I remember. Back then, I knew who she was, but I was probably 15.
Wow. It's exciting.
Yeah. It's exciting.
Yeah.
Good stuff.
We have to break, according to our Travis.
Oh, look at that. Wow.
That's from she did one called Tracy, I Love You. Oh! I think she was 19 when she did it.
Wow. Yowza.
Go down to...
Oh my god.
Wow.
I don't know. See her pipes.
See the one in the bottom. Go down with Tracy. Go down more where she's dressed. No.
Oh man.
I can't find so hot. It.
There was one though. Tracy, I Love You, I think was 19 years old. And that was like, or 18, when she just turned 18. She did one.
Yeah, definitely was
a piece of age.
Top notch.
She's got a De Mornay vibe.
Yeah,
she
now does. There's a Rebecca De Mornay going on there.
She was in Crybaby, right?
With her retard bangs.
That's right.
Yep. Yeah.
Did she have retarded bangs?
Yeah. Got them bangs that are too short. Like a lot of the Eddie kind Page. Of dyke girls wear that. Really short bangs in it. It's just ridiculous.
You think they're more going for Betty Page?
Yeah, Betty Page bangs.
Betty Page? That's a little bit more flattering to say than how Anthony described it. Yeah.
Retard bangs.
Yeah, that's
yeah, yours are a little more to the point.
Yeah, you know what you're getting.
That's tough.
All right, so we have to break according to Travis.
Our Travis.
And I guess Voss, where are you gonna be?
Oh, this weekend, Hartford Funny Bone, Friday, Saturday.
What's that? Good.
You don't have to say it like an interrogation. Hey, I'm going to be the Funny Bone.
Yeah. Friday and Saturday in Hartford. March 29th, Morristown Theater.
Might be the worst Funny Bone, by the way.
What, the Hartford one?
Yeah.
Why?
It's just brutal. It's in that mall. It's just a horrible
so people should
clientele.
People shouldn't go?
No, go Every see Rich.
Funny Bone's in a mall, pretty much.
That's not
Syracuse
true.
Syracuse is in a mall.
Another bad one.
Albany.
Albany's good.
Columbus
Albany.
Funny Bone's in a mall. That's a great club.
That's a great club. All right, sorry, Rich. Continue there.
Matter. Just go riotcast.com. Listen, my wife hates me, or patreon.com/Voss and Bonnie.
Don't you have just a link from your page? Oh, okay.
Yeah, well, there's a link on my Twitter. There's a link on my Instagram.
I see.
You know,
that's your boy.
There's
Rich
links
Voss.
Everywhere. Mm. Links everywhere. They're all the same.
A missing
all
one in your heritage.
Whoa.
Anthropology humor.
Fuck yeah. Anthrocomia.
It's terrible.
Yeah, that was bad. All right. Hey, come on. I'm going to be in Mohegan Sun for New Year's and Irvine Improv in January. Charlie Goodnight's in Raleigh. Helium Buffalo, Helium Philly. Dr. Grins. Check out MarkNormanComedy.com. Tuesdays with Stories on iTunes.
All right.
Very me and Joe List.
Check out the Chip Podcast, and the Christmas one comes out this Sunday night with Anthony Cumia.
Yes.
And there has been a very good New Year's Eve one taped.
A lot of fun.
Really, really good, good humor. We're going to come right back with Anthony, Rich, Mark, Danny, Troy, Jim, and Sammy.
Woo, praise Allah.
Praise Allah.
Kicked snoring out of bed thanks to Zeke.
No, I think Dennis just wants to do it because Rich was talking over.
Oh, no.
With a little package for you. Yeah. And it's a gift that...
Why are you playing the Candyman?
Oh, I love this song.
No, it's Billy Crystal.
I know.
Oh.
But it's not even Christmas. Chestnuts.
Oh, fuck this guy.
I like him.
Did you see Dan Denderson?
Yeah.
Billy Crystal was never good.
Ever.
I mean, like, not as a funny pro. Like, Harry Met Sally is a fine movie, but
right. You just never thought his comedy was marvelous?
No. He's annoying.
You don't like 20 minutes of him playing the jazz guy?
Yeah. It's like your annoying uncle.
I had my horn and I was going, Booyah, doo-da, yeah.
Wait,
shut the fuck up.
I happen to like Billy Crystal.
You can't, listen, no.
I can't dig it.
You can tell.
I never found Robin funny.
Oh, no. Robin's good.
You think Robin Williams was funny?
I didn't think he was that funny.
No, what? No,
I'll still help you model the end of your life after. I thought he was very funny.
Yeah, Mrs. Doubtfire, come on.
No, I'm talking about the stand-up.
Oh, the stand-up.
The movies were great. They were great movies.
As far as stand-up goes, he was brilliant on screen, but as far as stand-up goes, like, oh, look, he's so fast, his stream of consciousness. Yeah. Mm-hmm. He can take anything on the stage and make it funny. No, he can't.
Oh, look, a microphone. Oh, look, a noose. What can I do with this?
Yeah.
Oh, look, a belt.
Oh, manic depression.
Anyone have any Prozac?
No, the movies were great.
But the genie was great as the genie in Aladdin.
How did you like Billy? You didn't like
Gilbert was good as the parrot.
Face.
Yeah,
Billy. Yeah, I didn't love Face the character, but I like Billy.
Comic. Anytime they do, Robin did a fucking talk show. He's standing on the fucking table.
How would you know what you're supposed to do on a talk show?
Right in the kisser.
I don't know. It's just.
I just think that the comedians that rely on stupid characters are generally hacks.
Yeah, like, why don't you fucking mind your beeswax? Fucking Letterman Sammy.
Have you heard that's what they're calling me? I told you that.
Yeah, just tear down any wall no borders and let him in.
I don't remember ever saying that.
Let him in.
I don't remember.
But Billy Crystal, you can tell his mom was just like, you're great. Yeah. You're really good. That was it.
Oh, yeah. You're so good. Just do the characters. People love that.
Does your mom tell you that? You're great?
No. She doesn't talk to me.
Oh yeah, how was your Thanksgiving? Was it as awkward as we discussed it probably would be?
I was there one day, I got in, I got out.
What'd you guys talk about?
I think 9/11.
Because it's not like hostile. It's not like they're like shitty. They just don't have any interest in you.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. Sorry,
like my audience.
The public.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, wait, why don't you get along with them?
Well, we get along.
Your glasses.
It's just a coworker.
Huh?
This is like coworkers.
Like they make a water cooler champ.
Yes.
Do you really talk about 9/11 with them?
Yeah, the Holocaust, all the bad shit.
All the bad. That's a nice nice conversations.
Mm-hmm.
Do you come from a dysfunctional background? Like you were never like fucked up as a kid or anything?
No.
You're just a normal kid.
Your
comedy's like really
his
white.
Parents,
white bread stuff.
He's a therapist.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
No. He just said his parents are not interested in him at all.
I'm talking to him. Do you have brothers and sisters?
Older brother.
Do they like him better?
Yeah.
Fuck.
He's a perfect son. He went to the Peace Corps, all this shit.
You see? You're saying that there's nothing wrong with you, right? He's sitting here saying my parents have no interest in me, and you're like, yeah, but you were raised well, right?
No, but I'm saying what is his dysfunction? Just because his parents didn't
like him. His parents don't talk to him.
Exactly. That
just, did he do drugs or was he an alcoholic? Gambler?
Is he an alcoholic? How long have you known Mark Normand?
Still drunk right now. All right, enough about me. How about that Spicer?
He's still up there.
What's
right?
he up to?
Huh? Let's ask you a follow-up question. That's pretty insightful stuff.
I just don't know his background.
Yeah, weird background. Grew up in a horrible neighborhood in a dilapidated mansion. Turned into a bed and breakfast.
He doesn't know what dilapidated means.
Yes, I do. I'm looking at
beautiful?
It.
Yeah, good times.
How many bedrooms?
We had a lot. I don't know.
No, they turned it into bed and breakfast.
That's always the poignant question.
How many bedrooms? Yeah.
In a bed and breakfast.
How many square feet?
Yeah, who shingled it?
Yeah,
in New Orleans.
Time. Yes, sir.
Well, good for you.
Oh, well, then you know, like Billy Crystal when he was helping out after Katrina.
That's right.
How did he not get in trouble for just being a racist?
Well, he's not a racist.
Bit? Oh, come on. He gets on stage and he's like, we need help down here.
Well, it's not blackface if you don't paint.
We need some help. Booty dubby doo ba boo ba doo. Shut the It's just he might as well have had blackface on.
Yeah. Right.
Well, then you would have liked
dance a minstrel show.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
That's
You're
terrible.
Talking about being racist?
I what can't.
The
fuck? Look.
No, the second one down.
So at least I know what it looks like.
I have a mirror.
No, the second one down. Yeah. There you go. Yeah, yeah.
I never saw this.
Oh, this
it's
is
nice.
So bad.
I'm not
it's
a big
jazz
fan.
Man.
I'm not a big fan of this character
you think
as much.
His set list on stage looks like, all right, I'm going to do Jazz Man.
Oh, yeah.
My one man show.
I grew up in New Orleans.
Then I'll do the baseball.
Oh, this is only
player.
Audio.
I have lived in the Ninth Ward most of my trade cool life.
That's a bad neighborhood father, there.
He was in the Army. He was a trumpet player in the Army band.
This is crazy.
Is this an impression?
How he should have been crucified by
yeah.
a black group. It's like, really? We couldn't get a black guy to do this?
Right.
Well, he's just doing it. He did Ali. He did a great Ali.
Oh, crap.
No.
I wish he'd do him now.
Yeah, shake it up.
How cars?
So when I was old enough, I wanted to play.
What did he say?
You know, I went up to my dad.
Denny
was up.
I think he said cars. And how long does this fucking go? How long?
It's 9 minutes.
Nine fucking minutes of him.
Wow.
Can you even?
Sure.
The pomposity.
Is this only audio?
Yeah.
Pretentious dick fuck.
I'm a jazz guy. The trumpet players. Boss wants to know what pomposity.
It's a kind of bread.
Yeah,
could you
I mean,
imagine
that was,
having to sit through that?
Wow.
I mean, that was a bit long, but you know.
It was long.
Yeah, Crystal, Billy Crystal, Whoopi Goldberg, and Robin Williams in a green room has got to be a nightmare.
Wow.
Can you imagine?
Everything's funny.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez. Look at Vaz.
Oh, it's an old-fashioned telephone.
Oh, is it?
Vaz.
Oh, who are you calling? He's calling me. Zoobie-bop. Look, the Vaz is a trumpet. Ba-ba-ba-ba. And Whoopi shoves it up her box. Fuck her.
You two white boys are crazy.
She shoves it up her box.
Look, it's Ted Danson.
No, I'm not Anthony.
It's Ted Sheckler.
Ted Sheckler.
Yes, well. My bad knees.
I like those characters.
Yeah.
Ted Sheckler. Like right, the other characters.
Yeah, those are good.
The other characters are stupid.
Chip would be helpful at comic relief.
You think so?
Sure, why not?
Yeah, because he would relieve everybody of any sort of comic, anything.
It's hot in here.
A little warm.
We have air conditioning.
Oh. Turn it on.
Turn up. Yeah. Troy?
I made it really hot on purpose.
Why?
Just to be a dick.
You turned it
on. Good rich said he was
hot. I know. I was sweating. I thought I was having a heart attack.
I got a little music for you.
How come the police can't hold a comedy club down there? How come you?
It's all tourists. They don't want to see comedy. They want to get drunk and go to, you know, strip clubs and jazz. New Orleans. They can't keep a comedy club open. They open and close. Rich came down once.
They're all fucked up down there.
I came down to a club that never opened. It never even opened. And I was booked. There's some guy booked me in some place, and I booked the flights and all this stuff. Don't you? It was all over the internet. This guy.
Oh, yeah. Lucky's or something like that.
Not too lucky. Not for me.
Yeah. Everybody knew that was a joke. You flew down?
Well, I had a bunch of stuff strung along with it.
Florida,
New Orleans.
What was that? Captain's Quarters?
What?
Was it the Captain's Quarters Club?
I don't know.
Remember Captain's Quarters?
No.
Resco.
People do like to drink down there, though.
Yeah, that's all it is. They don't want to sit and pay attention.
That's all it is.
Did you get your money, Rich?
Donnie Brasco movie.
The guy was nowhere to be found. He ripped off like six comics or fucked up six.
How do you rip them off if he didn't?
Well, they rip them off. We bought flights, you know.
What was his excuse?
I never talked to him again. I don't know.
It was a hoax.
No, it wasn't a hoax. He couldn't get the funding.
Oh, okay.
He couldn't get the funding.
Could have been a ruse. Said,
whatever. So I ended up doing some stuff. I ended up doing stuff in New Orleans.
Did you feel hoodwinked? Stop saying New Orleans.
New Orleans.
Orleans.
Oh, no.
Comics
were bamboozled.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Nolans.
Run amok.
Got it perfect.
Does Jim Norton sound authentic when he says that?
Let's hear it.
Nolans.
Wow, not bad.
Is that right?
Well, it's...
Is it better than New Orleans?
Yeah, that's pretty brutal.
Well, yeah,
I
but
remember.
When you say, you don't say Nolan Saints.
Sure I do.
No, you don't.
I say the New Orleans Saints.
No, you don't. You go New Orleans Saints.
No, New Orleans Saints.
Did Mary Jean beat up Luis J. Gomez on
what?
A podcast
Oh, my God.
Last night?
What happened? Was that last night?
He called her a whore, so she went nuts.
Oh, man. I can see that. Mm-hmm. I can see that happening.
Not a whore. And her tits are out, and she's sitting on Soder's lap. It was hilarious.
She's an entertainer, Mark.
Yeah, she's lovely young lady.
Great cans.
Some of the pictures, it was like, I'm not...
What happened to her and Luis? I did not see it.
She's nominated. She's nominated for Viewer's Choice Best Titties.
Well, is she on the... what happened? They were... She got mad. She yelled at him.
It's weird because Luis normally is not an aggressive guy and doesn't rub people the wrong way.
Exactly. He normally is kind of tones it down.
Yeah.
Women love him.
Yeah, especially with women.
Mm-hmm. Do we have audio of that?
I don't know if it's on live.
The
audio is
out. I think it's
on Twitter.
The YouTube.
I read the YouTube cut off before the fight happened because. Mary Jean's tits were out, and you can't put titties on YouTube.
Oh, right,
She can go off at a moment's notice, Mary
Jean. Mm-hmm. Yeah, as a matter of fact, one of the moments that I'm sure will be featured on the Jim Norton and Sam Roberts Best of 2017
with Adrian
would include not only did the Adrian thing, I meant when she got into a fight.
The live performance.
At our... Oh, yeah, when she punched Adrian.
Yeah.
Underground, yeah.
Because I forgot she punched Adrian and then also got into a fight with a porn star.
Sure.
Uh-huh.
We should do another show, by the way, at the Village Underground.
Definitely.
That was fun.
We're doing, starting on Monday and then going all the way till Tuesday into 2018, we're doing the top 20 moments of this year.
No!
Of Jim Norton and Sam Roberts.
Yeah. Wow.
Wait, Luis has been, go down, let me see the other ones.
I think she deleted the tweets.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
But those are Luis's.
Oh,
I know.
Because those are deleted.
Available. The tweet is unavailable.
Yeah, that was hers.
Did nobody get her tweets, huh?
They're deleted. Yeah.
You look like a less hot me. Is that what Luis said?
I think she's Hispanic.
Yeah.
Tranthony Cumia.
Well, it'd be broke than broken.
Ouch.
Tranthony
Cumia. Oh, she's growing.
TJ Miller's TJ in there. TJ's face just
TJ's
pops up.
Killing it right now.
He's everywhere.
Yeah. And they said it's Comedy Central show, but they said, no, we made that decision in July.
I don't think they really do that. I think they do that like when they say, well, they amicably separated.
Oh, yeah, yeah. But I mean, I think if they knew
well,
in July.
This one?
Oh, that was the one from the Our Village show. Underground with Keith. Keith got in there. And
I wonder what number this will be on the top 20. I don't know. People can gossip amongst themselves.
She was mad at some other whore.
Like, wow.
Another adult,
entertainer.
Another lady.
Oh, yeah. Whore.
That's.
Okay. That's
I'm starting to think this lady has some issues.
Well, Mary Jean gets a little high strung.
She's a little bit of a temper.
We love Mary Jean, but she's a little high strung.
She is high strung. She's got a bit of a temper.
Sometimes she has a bit of a temper.
She's an angry whore.
Okay.
That's Mark Norman. We'll have to take the beating for that.
Bring it on.
Can only imagine what happened to make her like that.
Some people just get, they have no, some people have a hard time controlling their anger.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And some people were scarred emotionally.
Sure.
She needs rehab.
What rehab would you put her in?
Wherever Voss speaks.
He's inspirational.
The air conditioning is obviously on now, and it feels great, but it just goes to show you how fucking hot it was in here.
Yeah, it was
like,
hot.
I'm like, wow, this is nice.
I started sweating. I made it hot on purpose. Yeah,
if Voss has a heart attack, I hope it's on air.
Why, on a good show, though.
Hey, what are you trying to say, man?
Oh,
wow.
Taking it personally. Takes it personally.
Easy, Adrian.
She's not that hot.
Well, we have a phone call.
Oh, boy. Oh, shit.
We have a phone call. Let's see who is on line 12 here.
Oh. Mary Jean.
Hello.
Good morning.
Well, hello, Mary Jean.
Mary Jean, you're here with us as well as Rich Voss, Anthony Cumia, and Mark
Norman.
Mary Jean. Did you beat up Luis J. Gomez last night?
I tried, but they held me back a little bit.
How come you wanted to beat up Luis J. Gomez?
He's a rude motherfucker, and he's so disgusting. Like,
I've heard that.
He's so gross.
Yeah, and the sun came up this morning.
He is gross.
Mary, aren't you worried that it...
what did he say? What happened, Mary G? We don't know what happened.
He called me a hooker. First of all, I'm not...
Whoa!
I don't exchange blowjobs for money. And he kept saying how much, being very disrespectful. And people like that are so ignorant. And I needed to be his face, but Bob Kelly held me back.
Oh, that's a lot of tit on tit.
Are you worried at some point that somebody's going to file assault charges against you?
No, because I never swing.
Mm. I actually watched you punch Adrian in the face.
You know, that's a lesson learned in life.
A lesson learned. Very good. Right. You're right. Lesson learned.
That's a good lesson.
That shot that one up to life experience. Lesson learned.
Yeah.
You know, Judge, lesson learned.
Well, we're kind of worried that, like, if you're gonna be with our friend Nico at this convention in Las Vegas.
Yeah, you can't get him into a fight.
Yeah, don't beat him up.
Yeah, no.
Because what if he says the wrong thing and you try to, like, claw his eyes off?
Yeah, hold on. There's audio of this.
This is so exciting. I'm so excited. This is going to be so much fun.
Oh, hold on, Mary Jean. We just got... Mary Jean, we got the audio. Yo, fast forward it. Oh, no. Bobby has so many people in the room.
It's too much.
Yeah,
that's crazy. That's a packed room.
Yeah.
Just turn that down, Troy, just until we get it.
Her bosoms look amazing when they come out.
It was a Christmas show.
That's Bobby Kelton.
Okay, yeah. Well, no, they're arguing. Let's get put the volume up.
That's the argument.
She's covered up.
Go back low. I'm sorry.
Is that as loud as it goes?
This is why? The one thing. I'll punch your face right now.
Go ahead, punch my face. I dare you to.
So what? So you could, like, call 911 and cry like a little bitch?
All right, listen.
Oh, my God.
Just real Puerto Rican versus Dominican. If we could. We take this down more Midtown.
Listen, Bob.
Let's take this Midtown. Listen,
this is getting a little crazy.
No, it's the halfway point.
It's not the halfway
point. It's the halfway point.
What does that mean, Lou?
We're going to do another hour and a half. I got to go.
Dan's
got
to
go.
Is Lou fucked up?
No.
Who's taking the first one? She's a fucking retard. Let me explain to you why, okay?
Uh-oh.
She got mad because I made a comment I said to you about people, porn stars being prostitutes. And
wait, he's
privates.
There?
No, we're playing the audio from the show.
Guys.
Bitch, yeah. Go fuck yourself, you stupid fucking whore.
Guys.
He's a real ass dude.
Guys, come on.
The fuck out of my face.
Honey, guys. Dan, Zach, separate her.
World star.
Right?
Lou, come on, buddy. All right, it's over.
Damn.
Mary Jean, this is not like you.
Yankee swap.
Yeah.
Yankee swap.
I am shocked.
Damn. Lewis is just trying to get into the cellar.
Hey, everybody, have a happy new year.
Wow.
We love you here at the YKWD.
What is he doing? Why is he trying to fight a woman? It's insane.
I know.
Yeah, like he's like, shut up, you whore. Like, what, are they going to have a fist fight? Yeah.
I love you.
Yeah, any press is good press, I guess.
Wow, that is something.
So, Mary G, you didn't actually swing out. We could see you were just kind of in his face.
I was definitely in his face and my boobs too, but he's gross. The way he approached me as a woman, and he has no respect for himself.
Oh man,
he was abused. He was raised by a woman who was a real hooker.
That's true.
Oh man! Oh wow!
He borrows money from people. He doesn't have a job. He's like 6 years old. Still trying to.
I thought he's a comedian.
So many allegations.
In his defense, he was trying to court you.
Maybe it was a Christmas show. Was he just saying ho, ho, ho?
Yeah, I wish he was saying ho, ho, ho.
Oh, okay.
We all laughed about it. But he was really, he was like, he was asking for a threesome. I said no. His heart was broken. He started giving me a little attitude. I was
you, him, and his skateboard.
Yeah, he was being hateration, Anthony.
Yeah.
Why do you think he was sipping on so much haterade?
Seriously, Sam.
Right?
Yeah, too.
Fucking Sam.
Fuck him.
Yep.
Fuck him and his 7-year-old still trying to be a comedian.
Drink it some.
Damn.
Drink it hater light.
Yeah.
Wow.
Mary, how old do you think he is?
Like 70.
Wow.
Like 70.
70 years old.
He is an old guy.
I knew I wasn't the oldest.
Those Hispanic guys, you know, you can't tell.
Mary, do you think he's a successful comedian?
Oh, my God, please. Ha, 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 ha.
He might be up to this.
Yeah, in his dreams, because you guys are giving him airtime. Let's not even say his last name, because there's a bunch of names with that first name he has.
It's Louis Gossett Jr.
Yeah. Just say Louis J.
We'll just do his middle name, Snake.
Mary Jean, aren't you worried, though, that he's going to come back and probably say some pretty mean things about you now?
Oh, I want him to actually come to my hair salon. It's on 171st in Amsterdam. It's nice Lion plug. City Salon. They could come, and he could bring his all his peoples, too, so I could show him my fucking fist up his face.
Like West Side Story.
Well, no.
Bad news is he has no hair.
Right.
He has no hair.
Right.
Now, Mary Jean, did you delete your tweets?
I deleted it because I'm in such a good, positive mood. I don't need that negativity in my life.
Okay.
So I was like, delete garbage.
Teasing. Teasing, of course.
There's no rush. You're not going to hit traffic. You're in a plane.
Oh, but I got to meet him at 11. I'm way late. I lost track of time. Sorry, Mary Jean.
Where are you meeting him?
Penn Station.
Cool.
All right.
I'll train to the plane?
Yeah.
Oh, all right, John.
Train planes.
I hope he brings you into a room and just fucking rapes your mouth. I thought he'd laugh.
It'd be a great show.
There's no context because what he's doing now, we talked about off the air.
Don't even know what you're going to do?
No. We just think you just want him to go get raped.
All right. Yeah. You know what? Leave it at that. That's what I hope happens wherever you go.
There we go.
Hope the man who you think is a pilot fucks you in the face. Have a good holiday, buddy.
Thanks, guys. Praise Allah. Happy holidays. Happy Hanukkah. Good to see you guys. Have a good show.
Mary Jean, we gotta let you go because we're ending the show in a couple of minutes.
Oh, enjoy your Christmas. I know it's your last live show till 2018.
Yes.
So much good luck and love and cum and wet pussy thing coming your way.
Oh, nice.
But wait a second.
I hope Mary Jean makes the top 20 best of 2017, Jim and Sam.
I suspect she will.
And also vote for my boo, Spectacular Boobs on AVN.com.
Please, that's right. Viewer choice titties, Mary Jean and a titties.
All right, thank you, Mary Jean. Happy holidays.
Thank you, Jim and Sam Anthony. Kisses.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
There goes Mary Jean.
A lot of porn stars have hair salons, right?
I don't know. I don't know what the whole thing is
but
with that.
Can she make a living out of being a porn star?
Yes.
Yeah.
Is she big in the business?
I mean, she doesn't do. She did a few scenes this year.
Yeah.
But she does. She hasn't done like a ton of movies.
She used to run a place called Buck's Stereos.
Yeah. She was trying to open it.
Yeah.
But the bank wouldn't give her a loan.
And she was in the bank and they wouldn't give her money. And she's like, "This isn't fair. You're not being fair."
And then they told her, "This is what we have to do." So she started punching them about the face.
Yeah. And then she was she got the money because she was buying donuts.
Right.
And there was a robbery.
Right. The donuts story. Right.
Shouldn't be playing that country
music. Tragic.
Right.
But it worked out pretty well for her. Yeah. She got some money.
Well, she doesn't do the country music thing anymore. She went to the Adidas 80s hip hop stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I loved him in that.
He was so fucking great.
Don Cheadle is never not good.
Boogie Nights references, Rich.
No.
You didn't know.
Not at all.
Did you ever see Boogie Nights?
What?
You ever see it?
Yeah.
It's so good.
It's so good.
I fucking know Don.
No. You don't know him.
I do not.
We've interviewed him once. He wants no part of us.
Really? Was he mad at you?
No.
What do you mean he wants no part? I mean, he just doesn't come back to do more press.
No, he's been back a couple times.
Yeah?
Yeah.
He came up to me at the golf course and said, you're saying stuff, nice things to me, and then...
You're saying nice things.
And then I said, can we have a picture together? And I went from peer to groupie. His face dropped when
you
asked him to take
that.
A picture.
Yeah, well.
He does it with everybody.
Exactly.
Well,
I know I'm a groupie.
Peer.
he never thinks he's someone's peer, right?
Exactly. I never pretend I'm a peer. I'm always like, just keep yapping while we take our picture.
Even when you took one with Jim Neighbors? I have nothing today.
I'm so happy you just knocked
today
your glasses
wasn't the
off.
Strongest one.
And by today, you mean 2017.
Do you hear what Dennis said?
What?
He goes like this. He goes, today? Oh, shit. Dennis
killed
you.
Are you going to nap before four?
Yes. Have you ever seen me fail
nap?
On your show?
What?
Have I ever failed on your show?
Yes.
No, on his. Never. I only did it five times.
You've been wonderful. People,
people
are enjoying
it.
It,
you know?
I know, but it would be nice if some days you did.
that's not nice. That's not a way to go into the Christmas holidays.
I know, but for Hanukkah.
What's that?
You heard what he said.
I didn't hear it.
Yes, you did.
I didn't hear.
Put your headphones on.
You say what's that because
you
want
autistic.
A little time
to
think.
Put
yes, maybe.
Yeah.
It's called a stall method.
What's that?
Huh?
Stall method. You should be on your knees with a drill.
Boss is very quick.
Yeah, he is.
Not today. You know, hey, look.
Yeah, today wasn't a good day for you.
It wasn't a bad day.
That's going to be in his head now.
It wasn't a good day.
I
brought it up.
It was pretty bad.
You're going to have to take the texts and phone calls, Jimmy.
Well, I mean, you know.
Which I bad for.
Like, for instance, you know, we were putting together the top 20 things, and I was going, well, if Voss is really good on today's show, we might have to edit it. Travis, are you going to have to change your order of the top 20 bits?
No, nope, all set.
Okay. No changes?
No changes.
I'm feeling there's going to be some Voss singing in your top 20.
How many am I in?
Does Voss singing make it?
No.
Oh, darn.
Look,
that's a shame.
This is a big count.
I'm in the intro.
You know what? Fuck you. I'm in the top 10 pop-up videos this year. Oh, wow. I close strong. Good night.
This is cool because this is the first time we've been able to do like a long form countdown that's not just like everything we've ever done. It's only for this year, meaning that there the stuff we did when we first started, it's out of contention because we've been on the air for longer.
It's just been a year, right? How long?
No, October.
Bob has 10 people in that studio.
Oh.
I mean,
on a regular. Like he is
on the reg.
He always does that. He packs people in there, and
it's a lot.
I got to get a word in edgewise.
It's a lot. It's too much.
Talented people.
You think so, Troy?
I think so. When you say 10, that's Bobby and 3, right?
Okay. All right. You're fighting your way out of this.
Yeah. That's good. Exactly. Not a moment too soon. I just got that we have a minute and a half left.
Oh, no. Oh,
okay. This weekend I'll be in Hartford.
What are we thankful for?
Huh?
Yeah, but it's Christmas. Thanksgiving.
Let's still be thankful.
Joe, can I play one for Anthony before?
Go ahead, play it anyway.
Twitter in Times Square.
What do you got?
Me too.
We're going to send them all back.
And he's strong.
The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas
would be there. Oh, this is terrible. The children were nestled. Well, listen.
Who's this?
Who is this?
Sugar plums,
we appreciate everybody riding with us all year.
Thank you very much. Yeah, for the support.
Art Carney.
It's been a fun year.
Art Carney.
Hey, we got Anthony back this year.
He's rapping.
Yes, we did.
Yes, thank you. I love coming in here and doing the program with you fine fellows.
Just turn the music off. You or him?
Wasn't me. Look at this. I haven't touched it.
Well, I'm going to put some nice music on.
Blend into it. We're winding down the show and you just cut the music.
It's the last show of the year. You just stopped it abruptly like a fucking
DJ.
Drunk driving accident.
Not good at DJing.
You're like a boy who's been hitting the street.
Oh.
Have a lovely Christmas.
You were an MVP this year, for sure. I laughed till I cried every time you came in.
Yes, you were a hit. Anthony Cumia is allowed to come in the building, so we'll be having Anthony on as a guest.
Love it anytime, you guys. And of course, later today at 4 p.m., myself and Rich Voss at compoundmedia.com.
Yes.
Yes.
A marvelous show.
Thank you,
my
sir.
My wife hates me.
All right.
Patreon.com/VossandBob.
Oh, Sam, we got to give the staff their other stuff.
Yeah, I mean, the real stuff?
Yeah.
I was going to just do it off the air and let everybody think we're dicks, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, what? Bonus?
No.
Well, I wouldn't go that far.
Have a wonderful...
Nobody's earned one around here. That's the problem.
Happy Christmas and New Year, and we will see you in 2018. Thank you, guys.
Hey, guys. See you next year.
wait.
No homeless shopping spree?
Wait. See you next year. Cheers.